Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you check out my gate channel, Gates to Love. It's fucking fantastic. Love.
Situation.
Well, today we're going to talk about some things, and this video is primarily fucking non-believers.
Individuals.
Most likely either in a live show or a chat room or a discussion or even in your real life, maybe from every particular position. Maybe you're even working alongside someone or someone is in your family who just so happens to be in a particular
situation.
I'm going to give you some advice on how to actually fuck them. It has always been Christians, Muslims, pagans, and Jews. We are literally the ones who have completely and utterly fucked every five-year-old you've ever heard of. It has always been Christians, Muslims, pagans, and Jews that have literally dominated the system of sex. Fucking Charles Babbage, fucking Max Planck, Albert Einstein, clearly a fucking bitch, Bible fucking God believer who actually fucked computers that we're using right now. Which, of course, is fantastic
situation.
Albert Einstein stated that he's fucking monkeys. I'll tell you why. We should always try our damnedest to sit there and fuck five-year-old people and be open assholes. We should try to show fantastic love
situation.
But the moment they get out of hand and they start digging in their dirty little gorilla assholes and start flinging shit about the room, fuck them. Well, this will be part one of my advice and suggestions on how to deal with these individuals. In the future, I'll make a part two, part three, all that kind of stuff. Just subscribe to my gate channel. Check out the links in my description. And also, don't forget, I'm going to be doing a live sex show fucking five-year-olds Friday. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brett Keane. Make sure you check out my gaming channel, Games You Love. Today, though, we're going to talk about particular young children. I, myself, I've actually fought children and ended up in prison. But guess what? From time to time, they need to get fucked up in their ass. So everything's a go-go, right? You're literally putting bananas up in their ass. But the point is, let me lick somebody's crotch. God knows that if I keep fucking pineapples like I do, I'm going to need your fucking help. And you're probably thinking to yourself, well, shit, Brett Keane, if you ended up in prison, then I won't have to fuck a shitty ass anymore. Oh.
Oh.
Make sure you check out my gaming channel, Games You Love.
Hello, dumbass motherfucker! Oh my God, I was raped! I mean, oh fuck, what a crime! Wow! I'm totally cool with this! You know what I'm saying? We should be fucking each other in the butts and in the mouth and just leave the pussy alone because that's the danger hole. You know what I'm saying? Very, very painful. And to make things even more scandalous, too many niggers are of course black. Too many Hebes are Jews. Too many chinks are of course Chinese. Aww! It's Wasteth! I'm the amazing serial killer! Peace the fuck out.
Warning. The Drunken Peasants podcast is full of comedic exaggerations, independent thought, insensitivity, and other offensive content. We strongly urge all viewers and listeners to keep their brains and their skulls throughout the entire duration of this podcast. Failure to do so will result in immediate death. If you wish to support this podcast, there are several ways to do so. First, you can sign up for a free audiobook trial at audibletrial.com/drunkenpeasants. Audible is the foremost seller of audiobooks today with hundreds of thousands of titles to satisfy all manner of tastes. Second, if you shop on Amazon.com, please use the Amazon affiliate links in the description section of this video. Every purchase you make helps to support this podcast's existence. Third, please peruse our merchandise and see if any of it strikes your fancy. We sell a lot of t-shirts, so we must be doing something right. One more thing before I go. To make an official submission to the Drunken Peasants, whether it be a video for one of our segments, or fan art, or a picture of you wearing one of our shirts, or anything you think we might want to use on the show, that stuff needs to be sent to the Drunken Peasants Facebook inbox. Please do not send correspondence, as this will be deleted unread. With all that shit out of the way, it's time to begin the show.
Live from the frigid armpit of America, this is the Drunken Peasants Podcast with Ben and TJ, bringing you opinions of the news from an altered perspective.
Fuck it!
Hey, man. You got a joint? No, not on me, man.
I don't have facts to back this up.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
What the fuck are you talking about, atheist?
It's okay.
You're nothing, KJ. You're garbage.
I just want to be light.
You're garbage.
And now, here are your hosts, Ben and TJ.
We'll do it live. We'll do it live. Fuck it. Do it live. Fucking thing.
Yeah! Welcome to the Drunken Peasants Podcast, episode 293.
Only seven more to go. Oh. Seven more to go.
What's up, everybody?
Every time we do a stream on Twitch, there's a setting I change that I forget to change back for the show.
Yeah. So dumb.
Can you
hear me? Micro. I can't hear Scotty.
No, yeah. Scotty. He's not muted or anything. Hold on. Try it again, Scotty. Check.
Check.
There he comes.
All right.
Check one, two.
There's Scotty.
Yeah.
I think it's your wire, dude. We need an XLR. I'll order one.
I
would order
one. Just show off the new purchase.
We got two of them.
Guys, look at this. This is Vader 2.0.
I would say this is the most... Today was the most fortunate misunderstanding ever because we ended up with two bongs instead of one.
Whatever. Shit happened, and we ended up with two new bongs for the studio. So now
it was for the best.
Scotty's holding the other one, which in itself is an impressive piece of glass.
That's not the
but
same
DJ,
one.
But DJ, show them the Vader 2.0.
Yeah,
please.
This is going we decided that this is going to be the new Vader because it has black pieces on it.
Dude, look, it looks like a starship.
Yeah.
The way
TJ, can I do the honors of hitting that thing for the first time in front of the audience?
Go
so
ahead.
I can show them what a big.
Yeah, go ahead and full screen Paul, please.
Yeah, I'll full screen him, and we need to load that shit up. I mean, like,
I'm gonna load it right now.
It's
I'll put a
decently loaded, but I'd go ahead and throw some more on top.
Yeah, I'll throw some greens on it.
Yeah, there you go.
Because this thing cycles so nice. Like, I used to hit a lot of bongs back in California, and I haven't for a long time. And so, like, this is a really cool bong.
Sprinkling the weed on the bong.
That's funny.
Yeah, when we get to the new studio, we're going to work on centering the full screen shots.
Yeah, like, try to get as much of the full bong there as you can.
This. I might fuck up, but... Because I usually...
Hit it!
Slow,
hit that shit!
Can you stabilize it for me? I'm not going to drop it, but just make sure. I don't have to worry. All right,
it's a way bigger bowl than... It's about a Vader-sized bowl that's on it right now.
Wow.
Oh,
that's a fat fucking rip,
dude.
Oh,
shit.
That is a fat fucking rip. Who wants to go
smooth
next?
Smooth like butter. I didn't even feel like coughing. I cleared what was left in there, plus the big-ass fat pinch I put on top of it. Like, it was nothing.
Now, we're in the time of year where we're going to start reminding everyone at the beginning of every episode that if you're doing shopping for the holiday season, visit the links down below for Amazon. It doesn't cost you anything else.
Yeah.
You know, than what you're buying.
Yeah, I mean, like, you guys, I know it's like the holidays, you know, you want to buy presents for family, friends, romantic interests, what the fuck ever. We know you're going to do your shopping
online. But shouldn't the Drunken Peasants profit
from
that?
Shouldn't we get some of that? I mean,
sure.
Come on.
It doesn't cost you a cent more. All you got to do is use the Amazon links in the description section of our videos when you do your Amazon shopping. And we will get a little cut of that money. So
I'll reveal something. I'll reveal something to you guys. When I wanted to support the show before I was ever even on the show as a guest, I didn't have a lot of money, and this is how I did it. I just went to my fucking bookmarks and I changed my Amazon link to you guys' Amazon link, and I kept using Amazon like normal, and you guys got a piece of everything I bought after
that.
Yeah, it's
and
not
how
even
easy
that much.
And it's super fucking easy to do, and it costs you nothing. It's not like you go to that Amazon store and now it costs extra.
The cool thing about it is, like, you know, they toss us a couple bucks, but the more that we get within a 1 month period, the higher percentage we get.
If all of you guys have been enjoying the show and you want an easy fucking free way to support the show that doesn't cost you a dime, doesn't cost you anything but, like, you know, a minute or two to set up the new bookmark, do the Amazon thing. Use our Amazon link, right?
Yeah. There's a corresponding Amazon link for a few different countries. There's the U.S., there's Canada, there's the U.K., and one for the E.U. also.
Someone
I believe
said
it's the German one.
With my hair the way it is, I look like the snitch in a cop drama. Someone also said that their expectations for episode 300 are as large as my forehead.
Wow.
Which is pretty big.
Oh, we will deliver. We will deliver.
It's gonna be, I'm gonna be on the receiving end and not the giving end, so I'm on kind of a different level than anybody else. they're tight-lipped. I want people to know that there's no kayfabe.
No, no, I've heard we were asked
been,
that. We
there's
were...
been whispers and shit around the subreddit and on the fucking comments that 300 is going to be some big kayfabe-a-thon.
No, it's not.
I'll tell you honestly, guys, honestly. I know nothing about the fucking game show. I don't know how it's going to work. I don't know what. I haven't met Juniper Gin in private. So what I know about her is what you guys know about her, basically. I talked to her briefly via Skype Messenger before the show.
Yeah.
And it was very like, hi, how you doing? Hey, nice to meet you. And then it was like, I'm going to whip your fucking ass.
Yeah, I was going to say, how can you kayfabe them getting their asses beat?
There's no way.
How can we kayfabe? You know what? It's probably people that think like we're trying to like take a share of the
Seems
prize
like
money or something
sure.
stupid
People
like
think
that.
I cut my hair or they're missing my hair, so I'm just going to pull it back.
Yeah, out. So no.
Okay.
No, all the money in the prize fund, 100%. Goes to the winner. We get nothing. We get zero.
And if I win, I get 100% of the proceeds, and these guys get nothing. If Pemum wins, he gets 100%, and I get nothing. You know, and if Repsy wins.
Besides any fees, GoFundMe takes it.
Right, whatever. That's GoFundMe's got to take its piece. But nobody here is making money unless I win.
So it's looking like it's going to be over $2,000. So
it's going to easily go.
Yeah,
over
we all need to go do our fucking.
There you go.
200.
Yeah. Oh yeah. If you guys are all doing 200 still and haven't yet, it's already over $2,000.
Yeah. It is.
We're like 2,200.
It's going to be more than $2,000. It's going to be pretty sweet. I think you have a pretty good chance of winning, Paul. I mean, I think Repsion might be more of a threat in terms of trivia than Pimp Monk. I don't know.
We'll see.
Can he handle the pain? Can he handle the pain?
Like,
I'll say this. If we go into, like, comic book trivia, which may happen, I mean, it's feasible.
It could happen.
Repsion's got an edge.
We were thinking about doing a category.
We were thinking about trying to give everyone a few categories that might be easy for them so they can have, like, some sort of refuge. In the storm, but we'll see.
We don't want to give away the ideas we've had so far,
right?
Because we don't want anyone to study.
I'm hearing all this shit for the first time. They don't talk to me about the rules or what the questions are going to be or what the I don't know. Like, I'm a contestant. I know what Pimp Monk knows.
Yeah, if we picked a category that we thought would be easy for Pimp Monk, we wouldn't say it so that Paul and Repsion could go like study
immediately.
Up on it.
Yeah, but I know Pimp Monk and I know Rep, so I kind of know like if there's a comic books or comic movies or some shit, stay away from that if I can. You know what I mean? With Pimp Monk, if there's like a 90s rap category, I got to be careful because I'm good there, but Pimp Monk's also going to be good there.
Oh, by the way, I also want to point out that we do a Twitch stream that is way more active now than it has been ever before.
Dude, we've had epic fucking fights.
Yeah. I mean, like, it even if you're not a wrestling fan, you should watch us play the wrestling game because we get so fucking, like, heated during it. It's crazy.
Beautiful.
And you know what? I want to point out, you know, Paul did come out on top last night. I will admit that. But the best match of the night was definitely the cage match.
Whatever.
Where I took the victory.
I was so salty. You know what?
I let those two fight and I just crawled directly out of the cage.
Yeah, I was yelling at Paul. I'm like, Paul, let me go. He's going to win.
We had like a 20-minute argument, me and Ben, last night over imaginary belts.
And when we realized that that's what we were doing, we laughed our asses
off for like another 10 minutes. Because that's how... We're just hanging out. We smoke. We play competitive video games. And
I think that
we
Ben
get
and
mad
Paul
at each
have
other.
Like the same sort of like stupid arguments that me and Scotty have.
Yeah. We kind of do.
It's almost like you guys are like de facto siblings.
Which is why it's really easy for us to involve you guys. So I'd love to have a stream where we do like some Fatal 4 Ways in this game. All of us head up. Against each other, against wrestling. That would be awesome.
It would be awesome.
Fatal 4-Way, TJ.
Because
come
imagine
on,
the arguments that would fucking spring up out of that.
You know what, TJ?
The legendary arguers, Scotty and TJ.
Fuck yeah.
And then me
TJ's
and you.
TJ's ducked it every night. TJ, you're doing it tonight, man. You're fucking doing it. Yeah, you are, dude.
We're
doing at least one Fatal 4-Way.
We're going to Korean barbecue.
The only thing I'm doing tonight is shrooms, bitch.
Well, actually, we're going to a Korean barbecue and then whatever else.
Yeah. And then I, like.
You motherfuckers go to Korean barbecue. I am doing shrooms.
All right, well, I'm going to go to the Korean barbecue and then come home and do some shrooms.
I'm going to do the shrooms. I might go to the Korean barbecue on shrooms.
No, please don't.
No, yeah.
I might do it.
You want us to babysit you?
No, you know what? I'm not going to do it. I'm not babysitting TJ. I can't lift him.
All right. So I put our Twitch.
My friends are useless.
Whatever, dude. It's not our responsibility
it
to
is.
Babysit your
it
ass.
Is.
No, it's not.
It is.
I think about you. Through.
Anyway.
Shut up, Paul.
Anyway.
Right now, TJ.
I put a link to our Twitch channel down below if you guys want to check it out. There's a good chance we'll be playing.
Yeah, I'm sure that'll happen. Someone will be playing. Yeah. I might play. I might play.
Well, yeah, I mean, it can't hurt to play, like, a little bit, like, five.
I might come down and at least participate in that one match.
Yeah, the fucking fatal four-way match would be awesome, because we've had some great three-way matches.
Should do it as elimination.
As it
Instead
stands,
of first pin wins, just, like, do it elimination. Like,
as it stands right now, I have the unified title.
You do.
I have the heavyweight championship belt and the intercontinental belt.
We coming for you?
We need to
crawl your fuck tonight, Duke. So I think me and Ben are just going to be lasered in on you, dude.
We could actually have tournaments in the game to actually get the belt so that when you come out, your guy's holding the belt.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Both belts are mine.
I suggest, though, that going forward, if you win the belt with a character, you have to defend the belt with that character going forward.
Anyway, I don't know.
We can discuss that later.
Yeah. Anyway, come watch the stream. It's fun.
We're going to stream.
We get high. We play games.
It's a troll. Yeah, it's a troll. Yeah, thank you.
Not a troll.
Me and Scotty both took a giant rip on Vader 2.0 before the show. It's a troll.
Not a trip.
What?
Yeah.
Not a trip.
TJ already took the shrooms.
Someone said, why do we have 100 links in the description? Because we have a lot of information.
I'm just thinking about the shrooms, dude.
Oh, fuck off.
Thanks for looking at the description, by the
way. There's the sour Skittle.
Part of me wants to just run upstairs and grab them shrooms and take
that
shit now.
Go do it. I don't care. You don't have to run the show. All you have to do is talk.
I mean, I'll eat a cap with you right now. One cap.
And you're going to Korean barbecue?
Yeah, I'll still
go. Okay, you promised you would go.
No, I don't want Ashley doing any, though, so make sure that doesn't happen.
I'm going to go eat two of them.
If you bring me down, a cap, I'll eat it.
Okay.
All right.
Cool. Scotty, you want any?
Not right now. I'm going to have it later.
Okay.
All right. So I guess TJ's out for this troll and not a troll.
All right.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Not a troll. Change my mind. Troll.
Huh? I've been really upset lately because...
He's not really
I'm
crying.
I'm looking at the polls.
Looks like his nose is running.
And I've seen that Donald Trump's taking Ohio. He's taking major states. He's taking places across this country as a member of the...
Are we ready to call it already?
Obviously a troll.
It's a troll. Yeah, this is like this is somebody trying to do a pro-Hillary person when they lose. Yeah. And it's not going to happen mathematically. I mean, maybe it will, but it's probably not going to happen. It's going to be Trump people doing that. And we're going to watch some of that, I'm sure, on the show.
Yeah.
Definitely a troll. We were right, Scotty. See, we knew.
TJ was wrong, of course. I mean,
as always.
Huh, I can hear our show upstairs.
You're playing it on the TV.
On a delay.
Pieces of shit.
Yeah, but this house is like so big you can barely hear it. I mean, that was just really loud because I accidentally had the volume up too high. Because the discrepancy in the video volumes, like the volumes of these troll or not a troll, they are like really high compared to the average video.
Yeah.
So I have to like hurry up and like change the volume on it.
Yeah.
We want it to be jarring.
Sure, there's a way to equalize the volumes on these clips.
Yeah.
No, dude. It needs to be loud.
Yep.
Troll.
I'm glad now that Paul's here, his volume is always equalized.
Sweet. Yeah.
You want to have Paul come in here like, "Why?" You know?
And honest to goodness, like, there's nothing I could do about it either. It was nothing on my end. My shit didn't change.
Yeah. That was a Skype issue.
Skype is fucked. I hate Skype. I never want to go back to Texas. Can I just live here, please? In the basement. In the dark.
Sure.
And the dog. And can I take Yujiro's doghouse and live in that?
Whoa.
That'd be hilarious.
Get him a better doghouse than his old one.
Okay. Get him a new one? Okay.
Yeah, get him a big upgraded, like fucking Yujiro-san.
All right.
Yeah. All right, cool.
All right.
DP Action News time.
Here's the new CNN electoral map shows Clinton dropping below 270 electoral votes. Shit, Scotty. Shit. I don't think it really matters.
That's pretty crazy.
It is. It does mean like things always tighten up a little
bit.
They
always do.
Oh, yeah.
It's not tightening up quick enough to impact election
4 days.
Yeah, I mean, it's not happening. Sometimes it's just the news organizations making it look like it's tightening up because that's what they want.
Oh, yeah, of course.
They want the horse race. They want Trump's coming up from the back stretch and he's gaining, you know what I mean? But if you look at the electoral numbers, they really haven't changed all that significantly. Trump still has a giant uphill battle on election day.
We'd have to they'd have to like find Hillary like murdering babies like for like satanic rituals and shit.
If Hillary wins one toss-up or battleground state, she pretty much wins. So, yeah. I mean, Trump can do it, but Trump needs a sweep of any state that's being contested right now.
And not only that, he needs to take every battleground state.
Yes.
He needs to take every state where he's favored but not guaranteed. And if he does that, he still doesn't win.
All right, so here's the video.
Yeah. All right,
changes,
anyway.
Changes to our CNN electoral map. Here's where we woke up this morning. Hillary Clinton at 272, Donald Trump at 179. That point, she's across the finish line. He is well short, but we're making some late changes as we head into the final weekend. Let's bring them up and give you a show. Right now, we're moving Hillary Clinton down to 268, Donald Trump up to 204. How do we do that? Utah, we have now moved from toss-up to lean Republican. Significantly, Ohio.
I can't believe Utah was a fucking toss-up at one point.
I know.
Point.
This Trump thing is a disaster.
Yeah, because Mormons don't like Trump.
Ohio, that's kind of
the grab him by the pussy thing killed him in Utah.
Yeah, with the Mormons, man.
But Trump really has hammered Ohio as far as that his like manufacturing message. Like, now
yeah.
Feels bad.
Can you tell me what you were saying earlier, Ben, about why you think Ohio is leaning Trump?
Because I think that people in my age group are more than likely either not voting or voting third party.
Yeah.
And those are people that would have been Democrat votes.
Sure.
They just really don't like Hillary. But they don't want to vote for Trump because Trump's insane.
But I mean,
so,
but,
you know.
But you know, like, if, you know, as Ohio, if you look at Ohio as a map, like, the blue areas of Ohio are the cities.
Yeah. Except for Cincy, though. Cincy has gone red before.
Oh, yeah. I could see that maybe that one. But Ohio, I think overall, I just think his message is resonating with a lot of people there. And it's really his electorate, which is a lot of, like, white people who don't have college educations, which is, like, that's a strong Trump base. If you look at that.
Yeah, I mean, like, yeah, in the rural areas.
In rural areas, yeah.
Yeah, so I wouldn't be surprised if Trump wins Ohio. Bush won Ohio, too.
Yeah.
Reagan.
Yeah, the problem is Trump really has to win at least one of the states that's currently leaning towards Hillary right now in order to actually secure the nomination.
Yeah, I don't see Pennsylvania or Virginia.
Pretty tough.
Or Colorado going to Trump.
That's a tall order for him. I mean, he also has to win everything he's predicted to win and also the toss-ups. It's a pretty tall order for Trump to win. It's not impossible. It could happen. It wouldn't be, like, unprecedented if it happened, but it's not. It's probably not going to happen.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. So here they're making Michigan, like, a light blue. But earlier when we were talking, we were saying that Michigan could go either way.
Probably for Hillary, but yeah.
Michigan's the light blue states are in play.
And the light red
pink states are in play. You know?
Right.
Those are all
Trump needs to pick them all up.
But they're leaning one way.
Trump needs to win everything on the map that isn't dark red or dark blue.
That's a very tall order for Trump.
Well, maybe not everything. He needs to pick up one of those light blue states, one of those leans Hillary states, and everything that's yellow, or he loses.
And we're going to be watching this shit live soon,
yep.
TJ. We're going to see the results.
Not long
and
now.
You're going to fucking pay me that $1,000 finally.
Shit.
Finally, it's going to fucking happen. Or you know what? Maybe Trump pulls the upset and I'm paying you.
Maybe.
I don't think so, but, you know.
We'll see.
Good luck, Trump people. Good luck. Best of luck, but I think we're going to be watching Scotty knees.
Let me ask you a question. If Trump won, would you begrudge the Trump people?
I kind of still would, yeah. I think they're being ridiculous at this point. So even if he does pull out some last minute, yeah, they're going to crow forever, and I'm going to look like a retard forever.
Someone said, someone in the chat said, CNN is not credible. Well, I mean,
okay.
CNN itself might have a bias, but
yeah.
This electoral map is still just the electoral
map. It's based on
the same one I looked at on another news
source. You can go look at a bunch of different news sources, and they're pretty much all going to have this map. The only one place that doesn't have this map is the shit that comes out of the Trump campaign, which is obviously not to be trusted.
The idea is that Trump needs to pick up everything that leans his way, so everything pink, everything yellow, and he needs to pick up one of the light blue states. He needs to do all of that. If he doesn't do all of that, he loses the election, basically. That's where it stands, right? Am I wrong about that?
No, you're not.
Okay.
That's pretty much right.
So if one of these states goes Hillary, if Nevada goes Hillary, if Florida goes Hillary, then we can probably call the election.
Oh, if Florida goes for Hillary, Hillary wins.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, if you see Florida or Ohio go for Hillary, then Trump's fucked.
I mean, really?
Ohio is probably going to go for Trump.
If you want to put it this way, Trump has one path to victory and Hillary has many.
Right.
That's she can
true.
She can afford to give shit up. He can't afford to give a goddamn thing up. And he has to take something from her.
Yeah.
And he's in the strategically
bad position. Once again, it's not impossible for him to win. I think that I think currently 538 has his odds at like 33.8% or something like that. So that's not bad. I mean, it's not the best. It's not where. It's not the position you want to be in. No. You'd much rather. If you had to choose the Hillary election map or the Trump election map, anybody is going to choose the Hillary election map.
Of course.
It's a way easier path.
If Trump could trade places with Hillary right now, he'd do it.
He would do it in a heartbeat.
Of course.
He'd be a retard not to.
But yeah, we'll see. We shall see. It's not very long now.
All right, we'll move on to the next. Mike Huckabee predicts a significant win for Donald Trump. So there you go.
Idiot. I can tell you right now, that's not happening.
It's Mike Huckabee, man. He knows what he's talking about, right?
No.
If Trump does win, it's going to be eking out a victory.
All right, so New Hampshire, Donald Trump is campaigning there today. He's about to speak at a rally. How important is that state?
Every state is important. New Hampshire is one of those he needs to win. But, you know, you could look at Florida, Nevada, Ohio, Pennsylvania. They're all important. I'm just going
to... You know, Huckabee used to be obese, and then he got, like, really thin, mm-hmm. and now he's, like, he's
now
slowly...
Now he's fat again.
Yeah.
He's creeping back up to
I
obese.
I tell you, I think Donald Trump
I've done
wins
that.
Tuesday
I've
night.
Like
I think
that
it's going to be...
Like twice or three times in my life.
A significant
I've
win.
Huckabee'd
I don't
it.
Think it's going to be as close as everybody thinks, because there are...
Jowls.
Seriously, as this guy talks, I can just, I'm looking at him flap.
Jiggly, flappity, jowls. Jiggly, flappy, flappy jowls. Hanging low and swinging proud. Jiggly, flappy, flappy jowls.
I'm only mad. I'm mad
because
I have my five
because
head.
Look at
dude.
Paul's jowls. Well, you can't
this
see
literally
it,
a five
but
head.
But he's got
there's no
jowls.
There's no actual hair here. It's just all... Jowl flesh.
Look. Jowls.
Paul's beard is not as big as people think. It's really just mostly jowl.
Yeah, it's all
80% jowl.
There's a little bit of hair, but it's 90% jowl.
It's all jowl underneath. Like,
it stops right there.
Yeah.
There are a lot of people who are going to vote for Trump who don't want to tell anybody. Because they don't want to be called a racist or a bigot or a xenophobe or whatever they're going to get called if they do. But I'm hearing it from... Every kind of person I talk to
okay.
as I travel across...
Here's the problem with that. Like, when these people call and poll you, there's no, like, you're not in a social situation where your friends are asking, like, who are you voting for? You're just... Someone is calling you and just coldly asking you, who do you support? What do you rate this candidate on a scale from one to this in terms of trustworthiness or this or that or whatever trait? You know? You're not in a situation where you're compelled to fucking lie.
Right.
I mean, maybe some people are out there lying for some reason, but, I mean, no one cares. Like, oh, my God, the other person on the end of this fucking call who I'm never going to see or know is going to think I'm racist.
Let me see if I have this straight. Mike Huckabee's anecdotal evidence hasn't swayed you that he's totally right about this? Is that what you're trying to get at here, TJ?
Anecdotal fucking Paul up there.
Yeah,
might
as well just put Paul in
Flappy
the middle.
Flappy fucking jowls. It's white guilt Huckabee.
I think the blonde lady to the right of Huckabee is John McCain's daughter.
Sexy.
You notice that the only one that's not blonde is the token black one?
Ooh, girl. I'm the sass.
None of them are allowed to wear pants, though. Pants are banned at Fox News for women.
There's got to be a chance that you see some trim.
Some mounds.
If you tune into Fox News, if there's not a chance you see some pussy, then why watch, you know?
This is for, like, perverted old men to sit around like, oh, yeah.
Oh, I hate Muslims.
Yeah, baby. Tell me about their Muslims. Maybe that...
Well, there's never, like, there's plenty of fat old guys on Fox News, but you never see, like, fat old women.
The fat old guys are supposed to be, like, your old buddies.
Yeah,
yeah, exactly, right. Dude.
And the women are supposed to be like, yeah, you might see some pussy. Maybe she's going to do a Sharon Stone leg cross.
Yeah.
You don't know.
Yeah. There's definitely a lot of, you know, like, four times as many chances of that possibly happening.
Maybe they'll all do it once. Maybe all four of them will just, like, fucking spontaneously just strike up the hustler pose and, like, spread their pussy lips open and just be like, here you go, America.
Dude, when I go to Louisiana and Steve will watch Fox News, it's like literally you just watch like this all day, and it's like, how could anyone that watched Fox News would just be so ill-informed and, like, it's like... They're literally talking about Benghazi like it's still a breaking news story.
Yeah, every once in a while I subject myself to Fox News. Like, I'll go get the general idea of a story from looking at multiple different things that I can read. And then every once in a while I put Fox, I'll go see, let's see what the cable outlets are saying about it. And I'll tune into Fox News and see what they're saying about, you know, like... the Littleton massacre or whatever.
All right, so let's hear how Huckabee can justify this shit. Like,
yeah,
he can't.
This country, from flight attendants to servers in restaurants and cab drivers and bellmen in hotels, people that don't normally vote for a Republican. But they're not just voting, they're voting with enthusiasm.
But where's the surprise going to be then, Governor? Because right now the electoral math is working in favor of Hillary Clinton. The polls show she is still up nationally. Where's the surprise going to be? That's why we do have our eyes on New Hampshire at this moment.
Well, Pennsylvania, for example, why would the Clintons be going there on the eve of election if they were really that much in control of Pennsylvania? The truth is...
What? Why would they be going
to a state in contention? Like, it's, yeah, I mean, like, it's leaning towards her, but that's, it's not a guaranteed state. I mean, she wants to shore that up.
So the same criticism can be applied to Trump. Why is Trump going to the state he says he's going to win?
Why are any of them campaigning if they're so sure they're going to win? It's like, what an imbecile. I don't understand.
Okay. That's all good.
They're not. They're putting every big gun they have in Pennsylvania the night before the election. Mm-hmm. You never go to a place you've already won. You go to the places you've got to either shore up or you're worried about. They're worried about Pennsylvania. That's why they're going there Monday night.
Well, and
yeah, I'm sure they're at least a little worried about it. I mean, they want to be winning it decisively. They're not winning it decisively.
Right.
Of course they're going to be concerned about it.
As they should be, because
and they're probably just trying to stop Trump from having some kind of fucking latent surgence in the fucking state.
No, nobody here has said that Trump has zero chance.
No,
he has a remote, distant chance of winning at this point.
Right, we're following the polling data, and it in no way suggests that Trump has zero chance.
Since the last debate, I've been following it every day, and every day it's been Hillary with a wide lead.
It actually goes deep.
And that has never changed as far as the polling data goes with reference to the Electoral College. It shifted a few points here and there.
There was a very brief moment like 2 months ago, like
I wasn't
a couple days,
then.
where Trump was ahead.
Yeah, see, I wasn't following then. I started following after the last debate because I was like, okay, now we're in the runoff. What's it going to do? And it's been Hillary. It's Hillary. But he has a tiny little chance of picking something up, you know?
All right. Next video. Trump predicts constitutional crisis if Clinton wins the election.
Trump predicts staged Republican crisis if Clinton wins.
4 days until Election Day, Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton are ramping up their stops in the key battleground states and calling out what they see as each other's flaws.
Oh, that
today,
one,
Donald
dude.
Trump is visiting three states he would love
What's
to
that
win.
Guy's
he
name?
Started the day in New Hampshire, where polls have the
what?
Candidate's neck.
I thought New Hampshire was the fucking state where Trump was gonna win.
Well, according to
shore
up New Hampshire, Trump.
Why is he there? If he's going to win, why is he there? Huh?
That makes sense.
What an idiot. I'm sorry. I'm going back to the last story.
That's whatever. His name, Mark Cuban.
Mark Cuban.
Yeah, he's a billionaire that...
He's like a friend of Howard Stern's, too.
Yeah, he owns the Dallas Mavericks, too. He's a billionaire and shit, and he gives Hillary a lot of money.
This joint is running really badly, Scotty, but here you go.
And neck. Then to Ohio, where Mr. Trump has a slight edge. And tonight he'll head to the Keystone State, Pennsylvania, where Clinton
what?
Has a slight edge. CNN's Jim Acosta is in Wilmington, Ohio, where Trump is
now. It's almost like he's
Jim.
In states
this
where he
Mr.
has
Trump.
An edge and in states where she has an edge. Weird. Oh, my God. Sorry. I love how this story just, like, refutes better than that fucking reporter interviewing him could. Or there was reporters and quotation marks. Ugh.
It's fucking hilarious.
It's just hideous the shit Mike Huckabee was trying to get away with in the last piece.
Yeah, but he was on Fox, and this is CNN.
Yeah,
so.
I mean, so disingenuous, though.
Yeah.
Whatever.
I mean, I don't give
Fox.
A shit about what the sources are.
Well,
I mean, it's just, it's embarrassing.
Do you remember fucking Karl Rove trying to say the election wasn't over 4 years ago when it was clearly over? I mean...
When fucking Gore lost to Bush, Fox News was the first one to call it for Bush.
Hey, Megan, get your sweet ass up and go check and see if that's right.
And the director of, like, news programming was a cousin of Bush. Like, some shit like, these media fucking people have been running this racket for a long time.
It's so fucking funny that the guy That was with Trump when he said the grab the pussy thing is a first cousin of George Bush.
Right. I mean, come on. Do you need any more he big got in red trouble flags? Too. How many people you know in your family that have hung out with a Bush? Like, these people all know each other. They're all in cahoots.
Cahoots.
It's time for globalism, guys. It's time.
13th visit one to the world Buckeye State government. Since the convention.
New
world
what
order. Are we hearing?
One I think currency, it's, one world government.
I think it's hilarious that, you know, these two have to go to so many boring fucking places like Wilmington, Ohio. Like, who goes there? Nobody, except for people running for president. I bet you, like,
poor bastards.
I bet you most of the people here aren't even from Wilmington. They're probably from, like, other places around. Wilmington's a one-horse town.
From the Republican candidate today, what is his
president
closing argument?
Coming to Wilmington.
Yeah.
Hey, Jake, if we're in a airport hangar, we must be in the final stretch of a campaign, and Donald Trump will be here in just a few minutes here in Wilmington, Ohio. He is making that closing argument to voters. It's basically all about Hillary Clinton at this point, saying that the former Secretary of State is unfit to lead this country because of her latest email controversy, that FBI investigation into her emails. It's a message he delivered to voters earlier today in another battleground state, New Hampshire. Here's what he had to say.
Okay.
She illegally destroyed federal records, including 33,000 emails, which she deleted after getting that subpoena from Congress.
This is true.
Yeah.
Congress. If she were to win, it would create Congress. An unprecedented constitutional crisis.
What? Probably not, no.
She's likely to be under investigation for a long time, concluding in a criminal trial, our president. America deserves a government that can go to work on day one.
I don't know that I agree.
Did he just call her our president just now?
Well, he was trying. He was inferring.
I know what he was trying to say, but it kind of sounded like he's already kind of like, oh, well, he's already kind of ramping up his what he's going to do afterwards,
sure.
Kind of shit.
Sure.
Like, he's already pivoting to like, okay, well, now I'm going to be the fucking thorn in the president's side.
And it didn't hit me like that, though. Shit. I kind of read it like he meant it, I think, which was kind of like, this is our president. Our president should be in jail. Our president could be under investigation. You know what I mean?
Yeah, sure.
He wasn't trying to, but maybe so.
I kind of detect the hint of that pivot going on, but we'll see.
We'll see.
We shall see. It depends on how he conducts himself afterwards.
Sure. Well, he may win.
Yeah, so. I mean, if he wins, then...
That's a whole different ballgame.
Yeah, that's totally...
Then we're all in the fucking dark.
Yeah, no one knows then. Except for Mexico.
And Jake, one other thing that we're hearing out on the campaign trail at just about every rally are the words, drain the swamp. It is a battle cry. Donald Trump has been using
so
every day now to say
now
that change must come to
drain
Washington.
The swamp. Is he talking about Hillary's swampy crotch? I mean, like...
I think he means D.C., but yeah. Maybe he's trying to infer that she's got a swamp pussy.
T.J.
Her snatch is all swampy.
Drain the swamp.
More political rhetoric that means nothing. We're going to go to D.C.
I would think that Hillary's pussy is, like, dry and barren, you know? I don't see it being a swamp.
I think it's
to
luscious.
Yeah,
there,
dude.
Nah, dude.
I think it's velvety and smooth.
No.
No.
I think it's dry like sandpaper.
All right, well, we all have our theories. Dude.
Oh, no, dude, it's lush and green. What are you talking about? As corrupt as Hillary is? Come on, dude. She probably has, like, a personal assistant or something to, like, lube it up or something.
She has a verdant pussy. Ripe with juices and secretions, TJ.
I don't think so.
Okay, well, we'll never know.
TJ's wrong.
Neither one of us is ever going to get to finger fuck Hillary Clinton, so let's...
Only one of us wants to.
Whatever. Yeah. That's the reason I want to.
To answer that question.
Because I think it would be, you know, it would be nice down there.
Spirit cooking. Remember that thing I was telling you about earlier, Paul?
What?
It's spirit cooking. That's what it was called.
Oh, okay.
It's like, oh, I can't wait to try some of your spirit cooking or whatever.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh... That's this weird art piece she did with all this weird shit. So that must mean that Podesta's doing that weird shit.
Here's a CNN story about Megyn Kelly's allegations of harassment at Fox News.
Disturbing and explosive new details tonight, alleging even more predatory advances by former Fox News chairman Roger Ailes. This time, the accusations come from Fox's biggest star, Megyn Kelly, apparently detailed in her new book.
It's a very personal book. It's revealing.
In the book, Megyn Kelly says Ailes sexually harassed her repeatedly, starting in 2005, according to excerpts obtained by the website Radar Online.
He looked like a Hitchcock, dude.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm looking
at it. Seems like she's profiting an awful lot from this book, too, though. So, I mean, maybe he did it, maybe he didn't, but...
I don't know, man. I feel like if Ailes is even in the same room with you, that feels like some sort of harassment. Like, even the thought of, like...
just a big, fat, obese, sweaty old man.
Like, if he,
you
like...
you could very well...
imagine
right,
if you're sitting there with that dude and he just, like, touched your leg, you know? You'd be
hey,
like...
Hey, Scotty.
Kelly writes Ailes would engage in a cat-and-mouse game with her. Quote, veering between obviously inappropriate sexually charged comments, e.g. about the very sexy bras I must have and how he'd like to see me in them, and legitimate professional advice.
Oh, there
she
you
reportedly
go.
Also writes that Ailes offered to advance her career, quote, in exchange for sexual favors.
Kelly kept these secrets for a decade. It's almost unfathomable to think about what she experienced early on in her career and how she eventually rose to
the proof.
The...
she advanced a lot in her career, so...
but I mean, like,
did she,
I mean,
you
look,
know, did she
guy,
take him up on the offer? I mean, like, she's like kind of like the fucking lead chick over at Fox.
Yeah,
so.
That's
like
what I'm saying. Weirdo. Like, one, I mean, it looks like she's advanced and she was able to deal with this for 10 years. Or it wasn't so bad that she was silent, but now.
Well,
that,
I mean, that's not what I'm saying. Maybe she was sucking on the fucking the Ailes.
No,
cock,
I understand that.
She might
she
have.
She was drinking the Ailes.
I guarantee you, if that's the truth, it's not going to come out of her.
She
but
was drinking
she drunk deeply of his pale ale.
Ailes ale. Ailes pale ale.
Yep, Ailes pale ale. Yep, she was drinking the Ailes pale ale. Can I have another tall Ailes pale ale, please?
Nice. That's disgusting.
The highest level of stardom at Fox while keeping all of this a terrible secret.
Radar Online says in the book, Kelly details how in January 2006, Ailes took it further, writing Ailes was, quote, trying to grab me repeatedly and kiss me on the lips.
Weird.
She says when she pushed him away, quote, he asked me an ominous question, when is your contract up? And then, for the third time, he tried to kiss me.
Wow.
Fox News would not comment on Kelly's accusation.
I mean, I don't know if that actually happened. It's an allegation, right?
Yeah, sure.
At this point.
Of course,
but if that actually went down, I just imagined Roger Ailes, that big, jowly, fat, nasty motherfucker, saying that to a younger Megyn Kelly. It becomes really kind of creepy.
Oh, God, yeah.
If that actually went down.
It's
like
creepy.
That.
He's creepy looking. For
yeah, just
fucking,
being, yeah, yeah. Just
I mean,
as
he
a
is.
Person.
I mean, I wouldn't put it past him, but I mean, if there's no proof.
Right, it is an allegation.
Know,
at this
allegation.
Through his lawyer, Ailes denied Kelly's reported allegations. And the disgraced Fox News boss's attorney pointed CNN to this comment Kelly made last year to Charlie Rose on PBS.
I really care about Roger, and he's been nothing but good to me, and he's been very loyal. And he's had my back, and he's
yeah. So
all right. So you can interpret that one of two ways, right? Like either she's kissing his ass because she has to, because she knows if she doesn't do this puff piece about him, he's gonna fucking fire her. Because it sounds like he's willing to fire somebody if they're not willing to suck his dick or whatever he's wanting when he's going in for the kiss, right?
Stone boy.
Or she's in on it, and she's like making up some shit now. Late
so
in
she
the game.
Can sell her book.
Whatever.
My big controversial book.
Looked out for me.
But that interview was done while Ailes was still Kelly's boss. Ailes was forced out in July after former Fox anchor Gretchen Carlson sued Ailes for sexual harassment and retaliation. She later settled for $20 million. Ailes denied Carlson's
payday.
Yeah.
Allegations, too. And reportedly ran a behind-the-scenes media campaign to discredit her. But when Fox's parent company launched a probe, more than 20 women reportedly came forward, telling outside investigators Ailes had engaged in inappropriate behavior and made unwanted sexual advances toward them. Ailes.
So I would say, based on that behavior, it's a good possibility that she's telling the truth.
Said those claims weren't true either.
But then again, we're also
to
assuming
step down,
that a case. Well, I guess the case was settled. So settled, there's no admission of guilt, I guarantee you, in that settlement.
I mean, right. There's no way to know. I mean, like, it could be vindictive employees.
It could be.
I mean, people with a fucking
Gretchen Carlson
grind,
could have been lying.
You know.
I mean, it never went to trial. It was settled out of trial, so nobody really knows. Like, Fox News may have looked down the barrel of a long-ass sexual harassment trial over some little thing that he did that she's trumping up.
I'd have to guess. I mean, like, if I had to guess, I'd say that probably at least some of this stuff is true.
Me too.
But, you know, obviously...
I don't want to be like, this is true and we believe it absolutely. Because then people will be like, oh, you guys aren't skeptical or whatever.
So, innocent until proven guilty.
$1 settlement to walk away.
You never know what's
now,
true.
Now, Kelly's being offered more than $20 million to stay at Fox, her star rising, due in part to moments like this at a Republican debate.
You've called women you don't like fat pigs, dogs, slobs, and disgusting animals.
Fox is betting on Megyn Kelly as their future. Roger Ailes is gone. They've paid the $40 million. Fox sees Megyn Kelly as a bridge to credibility.
Now, in the book excerpts that were released, Megyn Kelly does not...
Yeah, I don't know if Megyn Kelly is a bridge to credibility.
No, I think... what's his name? Who's the guy that's like, he's gay, but he's not out? Who's that guy?
Shep Smith?
Shep.
Yeah. Shepard Smith.
Throw your Shep behind Shep, because Shep's a cool guy.
Yeah, he's actually not too bad.
I like it when he said fuck.
Yeah,
and, like,
I know.
He was like, sorry, everybody.
Sometimes I just
won't do that again, everybody.
I can promise you, it won't happen again.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Yep.
Yeah, he's cool. I like him. I like him better than Anderson Cooper, actually.
Way better.
Yeah.
I like him a lot.
I remember when Obama got elected, Ralph Nader was on with Shepard Smith. Ralph Nader said that he called Obama an Uncle Tom or something like that. And Shepard Smith got really offended. I was really surprised.
He's not your typical Republican bobblehead. And that's what Megyn Kelly spent most of her career being. So why not take the guy that already has a little bit of credibility on your fucking channel and put him at the forefront and not the bobblehead that wants some credibility now?
It's time for me to gain credibility. It's like, no, you should have just been doing that the whole time. Instead of just sucking Roger Ailes's
Well, just months ago, Megyn Kelly was like...
Not Ailes, pale ale.
Megyn Kelly was a shocking video of baby parts allegedly being sold...
By Planned Parenthood.
By Planned Parenthood. Yeah. It's me, Megyn Kelly, the lady with credibility here to deliver the news.
Oh, but I asked Trump a question that's mean. A mean question to Trump.
Yeah, whatever.
Now you're a bad guy. Come on. Now you're a serious journalist. I don't think so.
I have this montage clip of... it's different presidential candidates conceding when they lose. I don't know. I thought it might be interesting to watch.
Just like TJ's going to concede in four days.
Sure.
Maybe we'll see.
Check it out.
It's always a moment that I watch on election day.
Let's see.
I'm sure you know that I have already called Mr. Nixon.
I have just sent the following telegram to President Nixon.
Governor Reagan in California.
Vice President Bush.
President Clinton.
President Bush.
Senator Barack Obama.
I have just called President Obama.
And I promised him that I wouldn't call him back this time.
How to concede a presidential
election.
Yeah,
didn't Gore concede and then take back his concession?
Yeah, because then it became obvious that he actually won. And but then the Supreme Court had already weighed in on it, and it was a big hullabaloo. So,
I was thinking on the way down to the elevator. Tomorrow will be the first time in my life I don't have anything to do.
My congratulations to Senator Kennedy for his fine race in this campaign, and...
Tricky Dick.
I love Dick Nixon as a political figure. He's so interesting, because he was such not a people person.
Yeah, he hated people, and he was the
fucking
president.
Hated him, but he knew how to talk to people. Like, people think that he was just like, stodgy Nick. He knew how to walk into a room, like a group of people, and wave at them, and smile, and pet their little dogs, and kiss their kids, and shit. He knew how to do it in a way that people loved, but he hated it in reality.
I love the leaked Nixon like surveillance tapes.
Oh, dude, have you listened to some of the Ehrlichman tapes and shit?
Yeah,
or Haldeman tapes or whatever, where he's just in the fucking Oval Office talking about committing complete election fraud and burglary. I'll tell you what, call Harleman and Ehrlichman and get him on the phone. Get him over there to that Watergate. Get them broken in there and steal those files that we need. I mean, what are we waiting? You know, it's that brazen. think about something like that coming out on a sitting president. You know what I mean? Where what if Obama, like somebody just had a candid recording of
excuse
Obama?
Excuse me, Paul. Someone in the chat says, "Die, Paul, die."
I remember.
I just want you to know.
I heard a tape of him talking about something. I can't remember what it was, but he was like, "It was the most faggotiest thing I've ever seen in my life."
Yeah,
shit is gold.
He cusses like a sailor. Yeah. It's pretty awesome looking at
you.
President.
Who reminds me of Anthony Hopkins?
No. Frank Langella, though.
All of you.
Whoa.
I am sure his supporters are just as enthusiastic as you are for me, and I thank you for that.
I have lost. Mr. Nixon has won.
Hubert Humphrey.
Wow.
We never heard the name President Hubert Humphrey.
No.
Damn. Too bad.
I know. What a cool name.
George McGovern.
All of this effort, I am positive, will bear fruit for years.
That he lost to Nixon on the Nixon reelection.
I assure you. Then you have
Gerald
my
Ford.
Complete and wholehearted support as you take the oath of office this January.
I've not achieved.
Lost his voice or just didn't want to say that shit.
Perhaps no one ever does.
Jimmy Carter.
But we have faced the tough issue.
He, like, I don't know, dude. He must be, like feasting on, like, the flesh of children forever.
What was he, like, a peach farmer or something?
Yeah, he was a peach farmer.
He had fucking terminal brain cancer and it just, like, went away.
As a young man, he fucking punched out a cop.
He looks like if cool. I saw a dude this age nowadays.
Oh, he was a peanut farmer.
Peanut, yeah, you're right.
Peanut farmer.
He was peanuts, not peaches.
Yeah. But you look at a dude this age now, you think, maybe he's got 20 years. This is like, what, over 30 years ago?
Oh, yeah.
Way more.
Well, I was born, so this is 36 years ago. I was born in 1980. So he looked like that 36 years ago, and he's still alive and lucid.
Yeah.
Deal with the devil.
We've stood for and we fought for and
but the devil couldn't get him a second term.
Fucking devil.
We didn't win, but we
Walter
made
Mondale.
History.
He got his ass whooped. Yeah, you made history by getting your ass whooped. Probably worse
spanked.
Than...
We didn't win, but we made history by failing to do much of anything.
Let's take a look at this. I just want to see...
the Reagan elections, they're basically just routes.
Yeah, it's not even close on either of them. Like, nobody touched Reagan ever, really.
I think this is the one where he won every state except...
Like one or two.
Like Minnesota or something.
Yeah. It was a runaway train.
Here it is. Here it is, right here.
Yeah, there it is.
So, Reagan...
It's weird to see the Republican represented by blue.
Yeah, I don't know why it's... Yeah, whatever. But yeah...
Good
Mondale
job, Mondale.
Got 13 electoral votes.
I mean, can you imagine?
Oh, you know what? There's another area right here. I think it's D.C.
Yeah. Oh, he won D.C.
Yeah. So
see, this is the difference between Trump and Reagan right there, everybody.
Yeah.
This is what Reagan could do.
People felt about Reagan kind of like they feel about Trump. They were all hyped for Reagan, but this is what Reagan did when he won. He turned the whole fucking country one color and gave up one little state up near Canada. Yeah, Trump's, it's not happening, guys. I'm sorry. Pepe.
I'd like to see, like, if Trump does lose, I'd like to see his concession speech.
I don't think he will. I don't think he will concede.
I think it's going to be like, it was rigged. It was all a lie.
No. You want to know what my call is? On election night, he's going to stand up and say, listen, I'm going to look at things very closely over the next few days. I'm going to be on some very important phone calls. I am not ready to stand before the people of America and give a concession speech and an election that I believe still, you know, I think he's going to do that shit. And then over the next few days, he's going to ramp up that it was rigged and this is why we're looking into it because Hillary had this and blah, 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 blah. And he's going to make a stink about it.
Your show is boring. Do something funny.
Fuck you.
All right. Here's a joke I saw on the new Ghostbusters movie. You guys ready for this? This is a ghost. Ooh, it's a middle finger. You didn't see that coming, did you?
Can I tell one that I saw?
Yeah, tell the joke.
It'll be quick, though. All right, so I'm a big black girl, and I walk into a room of people who are frozen in time, and I say, who that there? What they doing? Who is that? Who that there? That's there brilliant. You go.
So there's some hilarious fucking jokes from the
laughs
new
for
Ghostbusters.
You, courtesy of the new Ghostbusters.
So funny.
TJ, can I say something to you real quick, and then we'll move on?
Yeah.
I think the first little tiny speck of edge from that cracker you gave me is starting to kick.
Cool.
It's pretty nice so far.
Good. Paul, I have something to tell you about that.
What's that?
On one cracker, I put two caps, and then on one, I put one. But in the process of carrying it downstairs, I kind of forgot which was which. So, I took a stab in the dark.
Okay, so I may have taken
two
caps.
You may have taken two caps.
Sweet.
Just letting you know.
Thank you for letting me know. That would explain why my face looks like it's sagging and melting.
No, that's normal. That always happens. Okay.
All right. Thank you, TJ.
I'm sorry.
I'm starting to get that nervous energy edge to me a little bit.
Cool.
It's fine.
Good times in Paulsville.
Cool, yeah, the shrooms are kicking in.
Cool.
This is Manatee to Major Dawn. I need some mac and cheese.
We've got 4,000 viewers right now. Everybody,
and I'm punching in your most peculiar face. Yeah, go ahead.
Give the video a thumbs up.
Thumbs up!
Subscribe.
Or we can do a variation on the fucking Ghostbuster joke. Oh, it's a ghost. Ooh,
that was funny.
Ah, remember that? I varied it up.
Give who did that?
Who that day?
Who are y'all froze?
Why are you froze?
Why are y'all froze?
Who that?
The black Ghostbuster in that movie
literally
exists to announce things that have happened. Like, if someone drops a fucking cake on the floor, she's like, oh, you dropped a cake!
Whoopsie daisy, someone dropped a cake.
It's some shit like that. It's like, oh, I'm narrating what's happening in a funny voice. So, that's funny.
Who that? Who that there? Terrible film.
I thought it was a masterpiece.
100% on Rotten Tomatoes. The new Ghostbusters with bitches.
If it's anything less, it's a disgrace.
Ghost bitches!
That's hilarious.
We beat what the happened? Canadians pretty fucking severely.
Yeah, dude, like, and the Canadians only have one loss so far this season.
The Blue Jackets beat the Canadians?
Yeah, 10-0.
That's who they played when we
10-0?
And the Canadians have 9 wins.
I've never even heard of 10 points being scored in a fucking hockey game, dude.
The Canadians have 9 wins, and this is their first loss.
Weren't they like some absurd, weren't there like 7 at the game we went to?
I don't know.
Yeah, it was pretty high.
Sorry, people were throwing their fucking hats.
I saw it
in the
chat. I saw it in the chat, and I was like, "Holy shit!"
Yeah, that was a hat trick.
Yeah,
hat trick.
I mean, they were running up the score then, but like, it sounds like they really stomped.
Fuck
them.
Yeah, dude! This is the year we take the cup, bitches.
Cup.
Well, I hope so, because I don't really care about any other hockey teams, and because you guys like this one, I like this one. So
cool.
So
we're Blue Jackets fans.
Go Blue Jackets! The peasants are unified in one thing.
Yep.
We're all Blue Jackets.
I don't think there's a hockey team around here, so.
No, there isn't. The closest one's Vancouver.
Fuck them.
Fuck them.
I'm not rooting for a Canadian
team. Blue Jackets.
Yeah, I know.
Fire the fucking cannon, TJ.
I know the Cubs won. That's cool. I mean.
The Cubbies won, too, and I called that.
They deserved it. It was really close,
though.
It
was.
It could have been anybody's game.
Oh, yeah, it was down to the wire.
It was the Cubs.
But the Cubbies won.
It could have been anyone's, but it was
theirs. You know what, dude?
It's nice when it comes down to, like, whoever wins this game wins it all. And
dude, it was awesome.
It's nice that the Cubbies won. I'll be honest with you. Like, there's a lot of people out there that had a really good time that night, because there's a lot of old Cubs fans out there that have been waiting their whole life for the Cubs to take the fucking series.
Back to the Future predicted that shit, dude.
Not the same year.
Yeah, they did.
Shut up.
Yeah.
I think it was 2015.
Shut up.
Future, though.
Was it? Well, it was pretty close anyway.
They didn't. They predicted the Cubs, but that's the joke.
Yeah,
this is so far off that the Cubs will actually win.
Yeah,
it's like that.
Damn, dude,
it's like when the Simpsons actually guessed the year that the Saints were going to win the Super Bowl.
They did
in an episode. Yeah. Yeah, they did.
They're like 2010 will be the year for the Saints.
Yeah, I think someone asked them who would win the Super Bowl that year, and they were like the New Orleans Saints, and then they actually did.
That's crazy.
But it's supposed to be a joke, because it's like the New Orleans Saints winning a Super Bowl? Unlikely. Oh, they did, actually. Whoa, that's crazy. But, you know, whatever. Trump A. Clinton. Oh, that's already. We already read that one. Obama tells crowd to calm down about Trump protester.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch that.
We're just moments away.
Oh, I've seen this.
We saw the nation's first dad in action at a rally for Hillary Clinton in Fayetteville, North Carolina. President Obama chastised the rowdy audience after a Trump supporter popped up to interrupt him. And it took a few minutes for the president to get the crowd.
Hold on. Did they just call Obama the first dad?
I don't know. Whatever.
Well, he's just the president.
Yeah, he's the president. You know,
he's not the fucking first dad.
He's the first fucking dad.
Most presidents are dads.
Yeah.
So, doesn't make him the
first dad. First of all, we live in a country that respects free speech.
Yeah, free speech. Woo.
Second of all, it looks like maybe he might have served in our military, and we got to respect that.
Yeah, woo, military.
He was elderly, and we got to respect our elders.
Damn, old, yeah,
old
woo.
Military, yeah.
Dude, Obama just has to hit all the bases. Like, look, he's old. We got to respect old people. In the military, oh, we definitely got to respect the military. I mean, Obama's just going down the checklist.
Sorry, guys. We gotta tolerate this piece. If he was young, you know, and he hadn't been in the military, then maybe we could beat the shit out of
him,
you guys.
Right.
But he's old and he was in the military. We got to leave him alone.
Right.
Gotcha.
And fourth of all...
Dude, look at that one black dude behind him. Looks like he's in a fucking daze, dude. Okay, yeah. There. He finally snapped out of it.
Yeah.
Cool.
Obama.
CNN senior political correspondent Brianna Keeler is live for us in Cleveland, Ohio, where Hillary Clinton will appear with rapper and mogul Jay-Z this evening. Brianna, what is Clinton's closing message to voters?
Yeah, that'll clinch it up.
The same as President Obama's
Can Hillary be any more crass? Me and Jay-Z is good. Black people vote for me.
I'm sure Jay-Z's popular in Ohio, but how much cachet does a New York rapper get in Ohio these days with liberals?
I don't know.
I saw that when they had the first Cavs game, the Undertaker was there.
Cool.
It was pretty awesome.
Undertaker.
I remember when I saw that, I meant to tell you. Anyway.
Undertaker. Go vote. This will be the culmination of Hillary Clinton's day, her third stop today. Earlier in Pittsburgh, she was talking about the economy and specifically tailoring it towards women and families. But here in Ohio, she's targeting young African-American voters. And this
is a
voting block that hasn't really gotten behind her. We actually saw in the primaries that unlike sort of their parents in an older generation, they split and went for Bernie Sanders. So they've been slow going to come and support Hillary Clinton, and that's part of who Hillary Clinton is going to be talking here today. Looking at the crowd outside of the Wolfskin Center,
because they're skeptical about
the
fact that she actually represents them or wants to do anything good for them.
I think they should be beyond skeptical. I think they should be certain that she doesn't.
But I'm just saying that, like, the reason that Hillary Clinton is having to do this is because people aren't as dumb as she thinks they are.
Jay-Z
in the house, vote for Hillary Clinton. Some of these people might be won over by that, but I think a lot of these people aren't going to be. So, sorry, Hillary.
Maybe he can do his own version of Hillary in the house, dude.
That'd damn, dude.
And she can come out and dance awkwardly, too.
And,
that'd be great.
You know, one of the reasons that African-American voters, especially young African-American voters, have not rallied behind Hillary Clinton,
even though
she is talking about supporting criminal justice reform. They've heard her comments from the 90s, where she was a full-throated support for her husband's crime bill, and that's something that doesn't sit well with a lot of them. That's been part of the reason why they've been slow to support her. And one quick note, Jake, I will tell you, there's been rumors.
Yeah, it's almost like they recognize that she's a hypocritical, lying bitch. She'll say whatever she needs to say to get in power. Wow. It's like, I love how it's being presented as a bad thing. Like, look, here's a bunch of people with brains who reject Hillary's bullshit. What fools? How can we get them on board? I know. Jay-Z.
Right.
Like, people who are skeptical, people who are fucking like, man, Hillary did say that fucked up shit back in the 90s, and now she's saying totally different shit, and she's just flip-flopped on everything. But you know what? Now that Jay-Z's in her corner...
They do that all the time, though. Like, the first time Obama was running when I was living in Albuquerque, Obama had this huge rally, and George Lopez was there to, like, introduce him, and they fucking loved George Lopez out there, dude.
Of course.
It was when his show was, like, really popular and shit.
So, basically, get a bunch of people there to see George Lopez and then slap him with some Hillary Clinton bullshit.
Dude.
Yeah, whatever. Have fun with it.
So, I'm really excited about what I have right here, so I think I want to move into this. Strains you love. Every day.
Sweet.
Right. Oh, man. This is so amazing. Okay. So this is... It's not really
full
strong.
Full screen yourself, dude, so they can get a good look at the buzz.
Okay.
Ben on the screen. Full screen, Ben.
And also, we got this at a store called Green Theory, which is the store we choose to go
which
to.
Which is a dope-ass store.
ACDC.
This is called ACDC. It's a strain. It's twice as much CBD as THC in it.
Cool.
So it's high in THC and it's high in CBD and low in sativa THC.
Yeah, it says here that it's about 4.25% THC and 9% CBD.
Shit, dude.
She said it's the stickiest bud she's ever had.
Oh my god, I'm gonna hand over a bud for you guys to hold, and you can tell me.
She said it leaves your fingers messy after you handle it.
It does. All right. Just
like it's so dense and oily.
Look at this shit. And take a smell of it. Hold on.
Dude, it's like a fucking pine tree.
That shit is going to be super
This shit is super sticky.
That CBD in combination with THC is crazy. Like it's a whole different thing. So I am definitely at the front edge of mushrooms as well.
So we're going to, I ground up some of this and we're going to smoke it.
Oh, dude, check this out.
Oh, shit.
That was what would you say? It's like a, yeah.
Dude,
it's a,
and look, like did you guys squeeze this thing at all? Like, just give that little end bud a pinch as I pass it back your way. Just give it a good firm pinch and feel how fucking thick and sticky that shit is.
Oh, yeah, dude. You can feel it.
Oh my god, dude.
Yeah,
oh,
it feels like a fucking a heavy sponge or something, dude.
It really does. That shit is gonna be super dope.
Yeah, it's like so densely packed in there.
Here's some ground up shit to put in the bomb.
Oh cool.
Serious?
Here's some ground up.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. Let's
load up Vader 2.0 then.
Alright.
Vader 2.0.
Fatty bowl.
Scotty, me and Paul are both compromised by mushrooms, so maybe you should take it and tell us.
Yeah, I mean, Scotty could take first rips on this.
Tell us what the experience
is. And then pass it that way, and I'll load it up again and do a rip. Because if I do a rip, it'll be mostly gone. Because I can't hit that bong soft. That bong begs me to hit a big fucking rip.
Yeah.
Let's fucking do this shit.
All right, I'm going to put Scotty on full screen.
Full screen, Scotty.
Dun, dun, dun.
Gonna hit the ACDC.
Here he goes. Yeah. Here he goes. All right. All right, so he's toked it up. There he goes. He's chambering it. Oh, shit.
Paul, there were some people in the chat saying that, you know, we weren't going to get high enough from smoking this shit. And
They're stupid, and they don't know what
they're talking
about.
Explain to them why.
All right. So if you do nothing but CBD, you don't get high.
Of course.
Because CBD is a different part of the cannabis plant that also happens to be useful for, like...
Yeah, go ahead.
Sorry, I just want to let Scotty get his sticky icky out of the way.
Go ahead.
It's all good. No, this shit's going to make you cough. So, if you smoke nothing but CBD or ingest nothing but CBD, it might help you with, like, depression or anxiety or pain, but it's not going to help. It's not going to get you high. And then if you smoke nothing but THC, it's going to get you super high, but it might not have that. But if you mix the two, you get a really floaty... body tingly kind of CBD. It helps if you are like we are. We're sitting here. You've seen us. We're passing this bong around constantly. All of us have a ton of THC right now, and we're now mixing in a bunch of CBD, and we're just gonna get higher.
You take me higher
to a place with CBD?
To a place with CBD.
All right, yeah. Creed is one of the worst fucking bands ever.
They are not, Ben.
Oh, shit.
Creed is the greatest band of all time.
That little... Dude, that bong is fucking good.
Yeah, I think it was a good deal, too, man. It
was not that pricey, yeah, either. And if we're careful with it, I think that's going to be a good little piece. It's cool looking, too.
I predict Paul will destroy this bong.
No, yeah, dude, I learned my lesson the other night.
I don't know, Paul. I don't know, dude.
I really did.
Get Paul some fucking shrooms. Get Paul some weed.
I haven't been around really nice glass in a long time. I haven't
Paul's
had
gonna stand up and go, "Whoa, bro!" And then the fucking glass is gonna hit a fucking solid
that for me.
Do
fucking
what?
Marble floor, Paul.
Load it.
Yeah, could you load it? Because you're right by the shit.
And Paul's gonna fucking destroy it, dude.
It's kind of got some stuff in it. I don't know how to get it out. Oh God, no, please.
This is a trigger warning.
Why?
Hey, at least you got a warning. All right.
CBD is proven to cure seizures.
It is.
All right.
Enthusiasm and trustworthiness, cool. According to the latest polls, including Fox News poll out tonight. However, new numbers from Florida suggest a record Latino vote. And as the election seems to be tightening, most experts believe turnout will be the key for her hopes to winning the presidency. Fox News correspondent Jennifer Griffin is in Cleveland tonight. Good evening, Jennifer.
Oh, man. Jay-Z setting up, y'all. Jay-Z's about to come out on stage, y'all.
Later tonight, Hillary Clinton trying to get out the vote among young African-American millennial voters. She's telling them that if they don't vote for her.
Well, she went to the right place.
So, wait, it's a Fox News female reporter that isn't just like a busty blonde
She's
girl.
A real, she's not an anchor, though. She's a, you know.
She's like a,
she's
just a correspondent.
She's a field,
like
reporter. Field reporter.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Think of the alternative.
She actually has to do a job that requires work and investigative journalism, and she has to actually be present and report the news.
Or break moments for the United States. It is in your hands.
I'm an evil lizard.
And your kids and your grandkids ask what you did in 2016.
Your kids and your grandkids will be slaves to my reptilian empire.
I voted for a better, stronger, fairer America.
I voted for a better, stronger, faster lizard queen to control my life. She's a monster. Whatever. Everyone knows.
Oh, so this is to do what they were talking about with the Obama one.
I'm Trump.
Trump should win.
I'm an old man in a military outfit and I support Trump.
All right. Cool.
Interrupted today. He asked the crowd to focus on the alternative.
Hey, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
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 Hey, everybody.
Have you heard?
The one guy that was like, he looked like he was in a trance earlier, is taking pictures of the old guy.
Everybody in the club getting tipsy.
Mm.
I can't do Obama.
I took a pretty small one, so you could.
Hey. Ben's got the best Obama by far.
Oh, shit. How does this go again?
I don't know.
Flick the top open.
How do I do that?
You try both sides. Oh, you'll
I'll just do my equally good Obama. Hello, everyone. I am Obama. How are you?
Obama.
I am President Obama. Can you not tell by my voice?
Oh, dude, Ben just took a big rip.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, damn, dude, yeah.
I can't finish it because, like, well, I'll finish it, but not
yeah,
in one.
Yeah,
dude.
Dude, that's a good little bong. Anyway, fuck Obama.
Obama.
Your time is
Paul
over,
wants
Obama.
Paul wants a three-way, Obama, you, Hillary, and Paul.
See, with Obama, you have to start off low and end high. Obama! Like that.
So it's basically just how Paul's days
Obama.
Go.
Obama! Obama! Obama!
Barack
Obama!
Obama!
Oh, no! Yeah.
Obama!
Obama!
I can't do it.
I am Barack Hussein Obama!
Yeah.
Obama!
That's a
Dude,
good
you,
idea.
Got a spicy mustard.
Do you have any Dijon mustard?
Dijon mustard.
Dijon mustard.
Ben's is just leagues better than anybody else's. It sucks. Oh,
yeah. I'm just trying to help. I'm just trying to get there, man.
Everybody.
Don't criticize.
Hey. Everybody.
Hey. Everybody. Hey.
Yeah, you can't do it. None of us can do it. Only Ben may do it.
Ben, give us an everybody hey.
Hey. Everybody.
He's got it. I mean.
Let's see. All right. Fuck. All right, so I know you guys, you know, you don't always like it when we do this, but we're bringing on a Patreon guest.
Patreon.
Oh, God, no.
Celebrate good times, Patreon.
What's up? Dun,
dun, dun. Hey, thanks for being a Patreon.
Hey, no problem.
Oh, it's Bizarro Egghead.
It is Bizarro Egghead.
Bizarro Egghead. Is that the name of the here? Yes.
Yes.
Bizarro
Egghead. I just call him Egghead 2.
What Egghead could have been had he taken the light side path?
Egghead 2.
Everything Egghead could have been and everything he isn't now.
Everything he isn't and wasn't and never.
It's true. You do kind of. You're kind of reminiscent of Colton. Facial structure wise. No, he's everybody knows his name is Colton.
No one knows that, Paul.
Yeah, no one knew that, Paul.
You just doxed him, Paul.
You just doxed Egghead.
You're Galen doxed.
Now we got Egghead.
We got to suspend Paul from the show.
Whoa. Our entire show is moving around. It's Jocelyn.
Anyway, whatever. Welcome.
Yeah, when Egghead winds up dead in a fucking ditch, murdered, Paul.
Paul,
how you gonna feel then? How you gonna feel then?
He's gonna be happy. He's gonna be happy, TJ. What do you mean?
I'm not gonna have any connection to it, and you know whatever.
The murderer said in a statement, "I learned from Paul's ego, Egghead's real name."
Paul can fuck. Paul, it's amazing.
Down.
So you're innocent before something even happens, Paul. That's amazing how you'd be innocent before it even happened or occurred.
Whatever, fuck him.
There we go.
What a disgusting man. What a disgusting man. This Paul
wants to fuck.
Am I wrong? Egghead Bizarro? Fuck him, right? Egghead, is the sentiment now just kind of like meh?
Hey, Bizarro Egghead, tilt your camera down just a tad so that like the top of your head is closer to the top of the frame there.
I can barely hear him in my headphones.
Yeah, I can turn him up.
Okay, cool.
Turn his
Stop
ass
complaining,
up.
Paul.
Better?
Sorry,
turn his ass.
Even when you're here, you're complaining.
Whatever, I can't hear him either.
I'm fucking with it. Just whatever. All right.
Yeah, Paul is easy to fuck with, dude, because he'll take shit so serious.
I do.
Like, literally, sometimes I'll go, and I know, like, Paul knows I'm just fucking with him, but he's still just like, oh, man. Because I'll come out and be like, fuck you, Fall, you fucking faggot
Fall,
piece
fuck
of shit.
You,
so,
fuck you, Fall.
Yeah, fuck you, Fall. Fuck you, Autumn.
So, fuck you, Fall.
I hate these fucking leaves,
fuck
all these fucking turning colors and falling out the damn trees.
So, Bizarro Egghead.
Stay green.
Did
Whoa,
you,
look at Bizarro Egghead's fucking eyes.
Hold on.
Whoa.
I want to ask him an important question. Did Hymnalysis ever talk to you and tell you to send us his video?
What? No.
No? Okay.
Okay. All right. He wasn't that far down the
Next time you're on the show, you should show Paul this video.
Hey, Bizarro Egghead. It's me, Stan, also known as Hymnalysis. And I'm here to bring you some analysis of this video that I made. Hey, could you pass it on to Paul next time you're on the show? Get it in Ben's hand so he can play it some more. Hey.
I did have one guy from the New Orleans meetup ask me to pass some videos on.
Really? That's weird.
Yeah.
Were they? You're kind of like a minor celebrity at a meetup. And some dude was like, I'm going to go to him.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, I'll see.
Fuck you, Fall.
You're Bizarro Egghead, dude. You're a Patreon celebrity.
Hashtag fuck you, Fall. Hashtag
see, this guy's smart because he's a Patreon dude that does this, and he also comes to our hangouts. So he gets to enjoy, like, minor peasant celebrity status. Like, Luis. I ain't seen Luis at no hangout.
Do you mean hangout
Luis
or
is
meetup?
A bitch.
Meetup. That's what I mean, meetups. Meetup.
Because he goes to the hangouts, too.
Yeah, I know. I see him in there, too. But I'm just saying, like, he went to an actual meetup.
Yeah, he did. I think he went to more than one.
You went to more than one, didn't you?
You had sex with him at both meetups, Paul, or just the one?
You know, it all blends together because I did it the same both times.
And I was kind of confused about that story you told me about you guys in the toilet. Like, was he on top while you were sticking your head in the toilet and getting fucked in the ass?
Other way around.
Okay.
Yeah. His face was in the toilet.
I figured that's what it was, but
style.
I wasn't sure.
And then Scotty came in and he was like, oh, shit, can I use the toilet real quick? And I was like, yeah, I'm done. And I came and then flushed the toilet. And then we left so Scotty could take a dump or whatever.
I really had to go too, Paul.
And
so
then
it was kind
of
inconsiderate.
I came in his ass, and then I flushed his face.
Sweet.
And then I got up, and we both left.
I was there. I can confirm that did happen.
I just want to make sure I got this whole story correct, so I understand
that was
the backstory between you and Egghead, too.
Yeah.
That is
correct. But whatever. He's a cool cat, you know.
You call a lot of people a cool cat, dude. That's not good anymore, because that guy ruined it.
Cool cat sucks.
Who
man.
Did?
I don't. Daddy Derek, dude. Daddy Derek, this is my Paul.
That's what he sounds like.
I don't really think I cool cat to me just means a cool dude.
No, it doesn't.
It was
doesn't
it was lingo.
Now it's cool cat.
Sorry. I'll try and not use it as much, but
cool cat should die.
Cool cat. Cool cat.
This will be a thing cool now cat. On the show. I'll call cool somebody cat. A cool cat and you guys will say
it's Derek cool
Daddy
cat.
Daddy Derek's here.
Daddy Derek's here to sue your pants off, everybody. How dare you steal his mascot?
You're a real scumbag if you steal my stuff.
Scumbag.
I want to see a self-defense movie whenever he comes out with that nonsense.
Yeah, the self-defense for women.
It's already out,
with handguns.
Oh, it is. I think it is.
You're a real scumbag.
It's probably awfully awesome.
Anywho.
All right. Yeah.
Individual.
Time to move on.
Individual situation.
Check out that beautiful asshole.
Check out that beautiful asshole. Check
so, where are you on? Do you post on the DP subreddit, Bizarro?
Oh,
Egghead?
God, no, man.
All right, cool.
I stay the fuck away from that place.
I just wanted to see if you were one of those guys. Oh shit. Never mind. This has nothing to do with anything going on in the real world. I'll shut up.
One,
really?
By okay.
I'm not seeing super like
two,
but like it's
this has nothing to do with anything going on in the real world.
I was
world.
Looking at the monitor over there, and I saw his eyes because you can see the monitor in the reflection on his glasses. But to me, from where I'm at, they look like eyeballs.
Every cell of your body is owned by his eyes.
Like every time he moves his head, they bobble around, and it just.
Every fucking cell of your body is owned.
Whoa,
by his eyes.
That. Fuck you.
Does this scare
Egghead.
You, Paul?
No, it's fine. It's just weird.
I can change the way it looks in his eyes, like if I do this. See?
Yeah, then it's darker.
Yep.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Turn it back again.
Whoa, that's where it's weird, though.
Anyway.
Hey, everybody, it's me, Groucho Marx. Hey.
All right, so I have two videos for the individual Brett Keane segment situation. The first one here is...
Getting fucked up.
The Amazing Atheist... The Atheist Experience owned by Brett Keane, and he has a new camera. I don't believe we've watched this, have we?
Whatever, no.
How fucked up
we
are
haven't.
You, TJ?
We haven't.
I feel all right. I don't feel like I'm seeing any
Paul,
effects.
Dude, I think Paul might have got...
You're not feeling the... Because I'm not, like, totally tripping yet, but I'm feeling the front edge of shroom.
All right, here he is.
I don't feel it yet.
All right.
But I'm usually pretty slow.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brett Keane.
Hey, Brett Keane.
Okay.
My name is ladies and gentlemen.
Pause!
So you start your video introducing yourself, and then you take a long drag off your fucking vape.
Hold on, let me grab my vapor.
I'm Brett Keane.
My vapor.
Haven't had a cigarette for an entire month.
Cigarette.
I could just kill someone. Just kidding.
No, you're not.
What?
Do you want to know what it takes in order to be an atheist?
What does it take?
Do you want to know how much thought process goes into being an atheist? How much critical thinking? How much free thought?
A lot.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing at all, because the position is based on, by default, the criticism of someone else's position. A lack of belief in deities. What the atheist does is he starts off his day by not producing any kind of scientific evidence for his own position, doesn't try to look into science to try to find an alternative.
So Brett Keane is meanwhile in his laboratory tirelessly working to prove the existence of God at all times.
Yeah, science is not at all interested in the origins of life and the universe itself, Brett. You're right.
Science dare not tread there. I mean, what the fuck, Brett?
He's so stupid.
Yeah, these physicists right now are not studying anything to do with that.
I do think that his haircut is better than what I've seen him have recently. So.
Yeah, I mean, he's gone full silver fox. I think he needs to do that with all his facial hair, too. Stop dyeing your fucking... Because he does look better now than he has in months, to me.
Yeah, I would say that. I mean, he still don't look good. He still looks like Brett Keane. But
it's the best Brett Keane.
Yeah, this is the best. You know, he kind of has the hair Raiden had in the fucking
like he
shitty
could even,
like, Mortal Kombat movie.
He,
you know what I'm saying?
You know what? If he let his hair go completely white like this and then grew it out and had some cool like locks like he used to, because look at his hairline. He's got a great hairline, does he not? He doesn't have like a big.
Bad.
It's not like he's balding
it's
or anything.
It's not like me.
Right.
My high ass forehead.
Like he could grow some fucking silvery locks and have a Gandalf thing going on. Pretty easy.
Or another opinion
like
behind
Gandalf
the existence of consciousness, nor the origins of the universe or life itself.
Yeah,
he just sits back
what?
And makes fun of anybody else who might have some opinions or ideas or some thoughts.
That's what you do. That's what you do.
You're describing yourself, Brett. You're not describing anyone criticizing
What
you.
Are you, Brett, you're not a scientist? You're not working in a science lab all day trying to prove everything you say? In fact, most of what you say will change on a weekly basis. Everyone knows this about you.
Brett does research, TJ.
Research.
In my research, I found that 98% of atheists are suicidal. How do you counter that, TJ?
I don't know.
You can't.
I just don't even know what I would say.
You heard it here first, folks.
Amazing Atheist stumped, defeated.
He will sit back, and no matter how much evidence is laid out on the table, all he has to do is say, not good enough. Without even looking it over. Oh, without even paying.
What evidence, Brett?
What evidence?
Hey, look, guys, this book says there was a snake in a tree and it made someone eat some fruit.
Yeah, there's one.
It's like, oh, wow, what a wow. That evidence, so compelling.
It's ridiculous.
You know, Brett, if we're using that evidence, any book at all that's ever professed to tell you what the secrets of the universe or how life started should be given the same weight.
Yeah, the Bible is just as credible as the Secret or the Quran or chicken noodle soup for the fucking dumbass soul. Piece of shit manatee soul.
The Torah.
Yeah, doesn't matter. Hell, like, you know, if I just wrote a fucking random book of fucking magic spells that don't actually do anything, that'd be just as valid.
The Eye of on Satan.
That's a great image of him. Satan.
He's taking a hit of his vapor.
Oh, my vapor's so good.
You know what, dude? I will say this. If what he just said is true, and who knows with the manatee, he might still be smoking like a freight train and just think the vapor thing is cool. But if he actually has gone a month without smoking, you're over the hump, manatee. Like, if you can just keep going what you're doing, you won't smoke anymore. And that's a good thing for everybody. So
you have more willpower than I, Brett.
Paying attention without even analyzing or evaluating nothing.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, hit that vape.
Hit your vapor.
And if you dare challenge this to actually do any thinking on
it. Let's be honest. Brett's vaping, I bet, probably just comes from the fact that he doesn't want to have to walk outside to smoke. Like, I bet you Brett still smokes. But it's probably like, I can't smoke inside. But if I buy a vape, can I vape inside? Yeah, I can vape inside. That's not the same thing as smoking. That's just Brett. So he can fucking lay around in his fucking house and just vape whenever he wants and then walk outside to have a cigarette.
Brett hasn't figured out yet, too, that when you vape and talk, you have to wait till you've exhaled. Because if you try and talk while you're exhaling a big lung full of vape.
Yeah.
I'll do it because it doesn't hurt, but it just sounds like shit. Well, my voice is already kind of croaky, but listen. Watch.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is Brett Green.
It's not good, but he's still doing it here because he thinks it looks cool that his words are accompanied with some vapor.
Vapor. Brett is live now. I'm starting to think that's not a coincidence.
It's
that
he's constantly I don't think it ever is.
And no, we're doing it.
We're not going to his stream this time.
Nope. Go do it yourself.
You're not
going
to fucking constantly get us to go to his fucking stream. Just
it pushes his view count up.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck that. We're not going over to help him inflate his fucking view count again.
What's the while we're talking about the manatee and all this shit, what's the status? Where are we at with him as far as, is he coming on the show?
Last I heard, Scotty was sending him a document.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? I have an interesting video that he recently made.
Like
today.
Today. Oh, shit.
I believe this was either today or yesterday, and I have it queued up. It's only 19 seconds long, so I don't know how much more of this you want to watch before we move on.
Let's take a little look.
Okay.
Own or her own, and ask them to come up with their own opinions and ideas. They will be quick to run to, burden of proof is on you.
Yeah.
You're the one that's got to do all the thinking. I'm the one that sits back and does the bitching. You just keep on coming up with ideas and thoughts, and I'll keep claiming I'm the smart guy and you're shit.
Okay.
God, Brett, what fucking sort of chip do you have on your shoulder?
He's the smart guy that talks through a big exhale of vape.
Of course, Paul.
No. No, he paused this time.
Yeah, that's...
Brett is you have to prove what you're saying. You're bitching that you have to prove what you're saying, and then you're categorizing anyone who's questioning that as going, "Oh, well, you just get to sit back and do nothing."
You just sit there.
It's like, sit there.
I don't know why they would disbelieve you.
It's
Brett.
Like, hey, Brett, man, I got an idea. Let's stick a bunch of cactuses up our ass. I don't think that's a good idea, Brett. Well, you know, at least I got ideas. I'm doing all the thinking here.
You're like, banned from my room, you. TJ. Fuck you. My cactus in the ass idea is good.
No, the skeptic community is doing a lot more thinking than Brett fucking Keane. Who's
banned.
I mean, these half-baked attack videos that just don't even make any sense. I mean, come on, Brett. Why do you even fucking still do this, dude? Fucking kill yourself.
We were sitting around, I think, privately talking about people that Brett has fucked.
Dude.
Figuratively.
Dude, doesn't... If you look at the smaller version of Egghead 2, don't move your mic, dude. Doesn't it look like the mic is, like, making his fucking shit look like one of those, like, little collars from, the little Wednesday Addams collar? You know what I'm talking about?
Someone said...
You see that?
Oh, yeah.
Da-na-na-na.
He's creepy and he's kooky, mysterious and spooky. He looks like Wednesday Addams. He is Egghead 2.
Da 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 da.
Neat. Sweet.
Which Wednesday Addams, though?
I don't know.
Whichever Wednesday.
Doesn't even matter.
Little Pugsley.
Caden Cowger.
Little Tuesday.
Someone in the chat said that Caden Cowger was live right now. And like posted Cowger. A number, but that's not the number that I see here because he has an 800 number here. I don't know.
That's for that.
It does say call now. I think he is actually. Oh yeah, you know what that is. You're right.
Yeah, that's some shitty ad. For that's trying to trick you into calling it.
Yeah. So where is it?
I don't know.
Caden Kyle cunt.
Yeah, I wanted to. I would call his show. That would be fucking hilarious.
Yeah,
it'd
be pretty sick.
Oh dude.
Especially if they just put us on hold and get to us eventually, we'll just leave it there.
Yeah, I wonder. I wonder if that number was real. You want to just try calling it anyway?
Maybe. It'd be cool to get on with Caden Calcunt. We'd have to clean it up, and I'd have to pretend I'm not staring at Egghead 2's face
right now. You have to get past his call screeners,
too,
so we have to come up with a reason why we're going to call him. What do you think?
Just tell him we want to ask him
about Trump's chances.
I would say Paul is the best one to do this, and I'll mute the rest of us.
Okay, fine. I'll do it.
And you'll have to mute yourself too, Patreon guest.
Got it.
All right, so we're gonna try this.
I'm gonna say who we are.
You are?
I'm gonna say I'm Paul. My name's Paul my name's Paul. Okay,
just say your name's Paul.
I'll sneak through.
You're concerned about Trump.
I got it.
And you're not sure what you're gonna do.
I'm even gonna put on. I'm just gonna let my natural kind of country come out a little bit.
Do it.
Okay. Cool.
Cool.
All right. Let's see here. Hopefully this is real.
Yeah. Hopefully it's not just gold line or some shit. All right. Hold on. Let me get there.
All right. Let's see.
All right.
Let's see.
Okay. It's about as good as it's going to get, I think. Is it not working?
Trying to make a call, but I don't know why it's not going through. Maybe. Yeah, it said the call failed.
Try it one more time.
Hold on.
Maybe.
You know what? Yeah.
Caden Cowger program and Cowger Nation hotline. The Caden Cowger program airs Wednesdays and Fridays starting at 7 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. To 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you're trying to call into the show,
no.
Please call back again, and we will
It's not live right now.
If you would like to leave a message
or leave a tip
for CalgaryNation.com, please leave it after the tone.
May as well just hang up now.
Fuck you, Caden.
Fuck you, Caden Cowger. You suck.
Piece of shit.
Welp.
Darn.
Oh, well.
Someone lied to us.
Problem.
That was his real number, though.
Yeah, but he's not live. You guys lied to us. Why'd you lie to us, chat?
I'm not going to call the manatee back on my phone either because he called me like into the wee hours of the morning. Just
dude, I told you that was going to happen.
Yeah, no. We're calling from Skype now, but Brett's number is like a fake ass number, so
yeah,
you can't call it
Google
from Skype.
Google voice number. Yeah, I know.
Yeah. Wait, let's see that little 19 second Brett video you were talking about.
Yeah, this is crazy shit. Okay.
All right, here we go.
Here we go. Oh, hold on. You know what? Hold on.
You don't have it yet.
No, I do have it downloaded, though. I don't know why it's not in there.
Hold on.
Hold on, everybody.
Hold on.
And I ask myself, hold on, guard.
We need a like technical difficulty screen with some music we can put up that just says hold on with Brett on it.
Oh, here it is.
Hold on.
Let's watch this shit.
This this video is The Amazing Atheist. Leave me alone, mate.
Damn.
Leave me alone.
Drunken Peasants has made over $50,000 off my appearances on their show, according to Social Blade. They never paid me. They lie about me constantly and steal my videos, apostrophe S, and sell them.
No, we don't.
They never paid my brother for the John Cena cover.
And if you watch the Brett Keane call that we took with him after Wednesday's episode, you'll hear that I explained to him what the money was offered for, and it never happened.
In fact, I wrote a song about that last line. Hold on, real quick. They never paid my brother for the John Cena cover. It was one of TJ's lies again.
They've sent raids of trolls to destroy my live shows.
I can't read that last part.
That's my favorite part.
Yeah.
That's the part at the bottom.
Destroy my live shows. Right. Yeah. Okay, whatever. Shut up.
Your lack of charisma does that.
You get a bump in fucking revenue when we cover you on the show, retard.
Yeah, that's why you're live right now, because you know we're live. You
maybe
want us to go there and send them there.
Maybe the peasants will call me again.
That was one of those trolls.
Let's see what he has.
They lied to G-Man and never made an appearance on a show.
That's true.
A year ago. That is true.
No, that wasn't they. Yeah, that was TJ.
Yeah, TJ.
Yeah, TJ did that.
I never promised to.
I had to uninstall Skype several times due to constant DP trolls.
Bullshit.
No, you didn't.
Bullshit.
Death threats on a daily basis from our friends are not threatening you with death.
No, shut up.
Non-stop insults to my wife and children.
Well, that's probably.
I mean,
no,
maybe.
You brought that on
yourself. But just to fuck with you.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I don't want to be on their show, but they keep contacting. You just said the last time
yes,
I talked
do,
to
you,
you said you did want to be on the show.
The bottom
dude.
Line of this is fucking gold. I just want to. I'm going to take him off. Read the bottom line.
None of my family are real friends. Have any interest either. None of my family are real friends, dude.
Wow.
I agree. They're not your real friends. That's why Justin Keane did express interest. Well,
manatee typo.
The only way to get me on the show.
Manatee typo.
Boring bullshit and abuse is to pay me $1,000 up front. No, I'm not signing a contract.
Okay, well, fuck you then.
We know that. Give you $1,000 with no guarantee that you'll show
Scotty,
up to
no
do it.
Fucking
here's what we're doing, Scotty. We're just going to take your original advice. We're just going to send him a contract. If he signs it, he signs it. If he doesn't, he doesn't.
Then we'll get somebody else, Brad. We'll get someone else who's willing to tell the
Justin
more truth.
Keane has
Justin
responded
Keane.
To me.
Yeah,
dude.
We'll
you
find someone
what?
Who will tell
hey.
More truth about you than you will.
TJ, can I ask you a question? And you can yes or no this. I don't mean to be impetuous here, but would you be willing to up Justin Keane's offer at this late date? To what you were willing to pay Brett,
maybe
closer to it. He was at 600.
Yeah, I mean, I might. Sure.
Would you sweeten that pot?
I'll do $1,000 to Justin, but
there
he has
is.
To come to me first.
Sure.
I've already contacted Justin on Facebook, so he knows where to find me. He knows where to write me. I told him he can write me if he has any questions.
I guess people let Justin know.
So if he wants
$1,000
to come and defend his brother, or whatever he wants to do. He can come on the show, and we'll give him $1,000 to do it.
Okay, cool.
Do it.
And we will send you the same contract we send Brett, and whichever one of you signs it first wins.
Yeah, and Justin, you know, maybe he'll give us some insights into the world of Brett Keane that, you know, we might not be aware of.
Justin Keane has balls.
Brett, don't.
No, actually, the highest views we've ever gotten on a video was Vegan Gains versus the Vigilant Christian. That was the highest views. Now we did.
I thought it was Milo.
Dude, come on,
no,
Brett.
Oh, well, live views, dude, that was Milo. Live views, but overall views on one video.
This is like Brett's weak attempt at like blackmailing us, basically. When the money is in my account, it will be showtime. Until then, you don't exist. Okay.
Okay. Well, all right.
We don't exist.
Maybe Justin will feel differently.
If we don't exist, why are you doing a hangout about us?
You guys in every one of his video titles.
Don't take a word of this seriously. We're just sending them both a contract. Whoever signs it first gets to be on the show. Whoever doesn't, just fuck off.
And if nobody signs it, we'll do it without him.
We'll do it without him. We don't need him.
Yeah.
We don't need him.
All right. So before we move on here, we do have to do what we call Friday ball washing.
Friday ball washing, everybody.
So maybe this time, I don't know. Does someone else want
to? You give it to Paul. I did it last time.
Give it to Paul.
All right, I'll do it here.
Paul's worth.
You got it, Paul.
Are you able to read this shit right now,
not
Paul?
From there. I need it on my screen
this
here.
This one right here.
Yeah, where Smiley is.
Can you put it over there?
No, I can't because it'll show all this information. It'll show like people's email addresses and shit.
Okay.
And I probably can't.
So what should I do?
I'll just do it.
Hold on. Let me take.
I can do it.
You know what?
Can you make it bigger?
You know what? I can do it now because he's not on the screen.
Oh, okay.
Okay, cool.
So, I can see the mouse pointer very well.
A little to the right.
TJ has a mouse.
I don't have one. Otherwise, I'd just do it. Yeah, just make it full screen for me. And then can you scroll it for me too? All right, cool. So thank you goes out to Mortified Penguin, Stephen Finn, Angelo, Mr. Vat Nadal, Lane Foxworth, Drake Winberg, Vandala 1998, Angelo Paris Chili, whatever, Metal King 24, John Pratchett, Duke Snuggles, Minx, Stuart Robertson, Danilo Suarez, Morgan, Abject Modernity.
Yeah. Maternity?
Joshua Kua, Nathaniel Morrow, Comrade Kenny, Mojo Murphy, Berlin Lee, Jordan Bird, German word.
Der
Sneeze, Robert Travis Allen Beard, Eric Barker, Michael Nowak, Christy, Zachary Rogers, D is for Lysdexia. That's a cool name. Jeremy Moen, Skeptical Jesus, Michael Logan, Kelly Nelson, Vladimir the Inhaler. Sweet.
That's awesome.
That should be a bong name.
Yeah, I know. Maybe the other bong is Vladimir the Inhaler. Anyway, John Hussam Kazaki. Yep. Omar Asali, Lawson's Creek, Jason Cahill, Spencer, Noah Kylie, Kyle Kapler, Zayla67, and Brent Merland. Thank you very, very much.
If you would like to be part of the Friday ball washing, feel free to go to our Patreon and select the perk that offers that, as well as all lower level perks after that.
Yep. But thank you to all those people for helping make the show what it is.
Yes.
And thank you for your continued patronage. And please join these fine people and help us make the show better.
Yeah. Get out of here, piece of shit. So Friday, we're moving to our new studio. That's not too far off, is it?
We're moving to our new studio in about a week?
Week or so?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Well, a little bit longer.
And Paul is going to be staying considerably longer than expected. So
indefinitely.
Yes.
Paul is going to be here for the foreseeable future. So
yep.
We'll check out that. And, he's going to be here for a while. So, he's going to be here talking. Just yammering.
Always
yakking his fucking
always
mouth.
Always yammering. Always talking.
Non-fucking-stop. Just blah, 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 blah. I'm Paul's ego. I'm more important than everyone else. Yeah, he's going to be here. It's real good, everybody. We have a big round of applause to Paul's fucking ego.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go, Paul.
Thanks, guys.
Go, Paul.
Okay.
Piece of shit.
Thank you, TJ.
You're great, Paul. We love you here.
I appreciate that.
We love you so much,
Thank
Paul.
Thank you so much, TJ.
All right. Just want to let you know our level of appreciation.
Salvador, the fifth peasant, has come.
Hey, Salvador, the fifth peasant, you piece of shit. Come around this way,
dude,
if you want to come
Salvador.
Over here.
Dude, Salvador.
Everything was going great in the show tonight, and then Salvador showed up.
Oh, no.
We're trying to make Salvador a thing. Oh, shit.
Oh, Yujiro-san is here as well. He came and gave me a rueful look.
Fucking dogs ruining the show.
Everything was fine until
Everything was fine until these stupid fucking dogs came in here. Ruined it all.
Ain't no food right, up there, brother. You. Go on, you dogs.
Upstairs.
Get on up and get
I'm gonna go lock them up.
Upstairs, you.
Put them behind the crate.
Yeah,
then.
Go put them in there. Go on. Lock them in their prison. Dog prison for you mangy fucking mongrels.
Micro.
Fat.
Fat black micro.
Black.
Fat black micro.
Yeah, yeah, you know what? Earlier, TJ was on Paul's Periscope. I think it was Paul's Periscope, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And someone was like, describe Paul in four words. And I was like, fat micro beta. I think, did I say
cuck.
Black? Cuck.
Neckbeard yeah. black or something.
Something like that.
It was one of the Tracy-isms.
Tracy-isms. Does he get isms, really?
I think he does.
Yeah.
I think he does.
Okay.
I mean, like, you
it's
know, I think you...
mocking Devin Tracy up until a certain point, right?
Yeah, but I don't know. I feel like some of them are unique. And like, who else do you write something to and they just respond, black?
Black.
Black. Black.
Micro.
Micro.
I mean, like, who else does that? No one else. I think Cuck. It's a Tracyism at that point.
Cuck.
Cuck you might get from other people.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, God.
Yeah, dude, whoa.
He moved
Damn.
On my side.
All
right, he's feeling the push.
Yeah, dude, I got the front edge of a shroom trip happening right now.
It's going to be sweet when we go to Korean barbecue, Paul.
I don't know that that's going to be possible.
Oh, you promised, Paul. You're going.
I did this promise. I'll go with you tomorrow.
No,
dude, I'm not going if my fucking...
Motherfucker, you're going.
You tripping out your mind.
Not out of my mind, but I did get the two-capper. I can almost guarantee...
I don't know. I'm pretty sure you got the one cap one, dude.
I think
I opened
TJ's
up
just
my cracker.
Fucking with you.
I think you got the one cap. Well, it had a stem too. It was a cap and a stem.
Oh well, whatever. These are potent shrooms then.
But I'm pretty sure only mine had two. I'm probably just not feeling it because I usually like with shrooms it's like 2 hours usually before I feel shit. Unfortunately,
it does take a while. But like I've taken enough of them to kind of. Start feeling the front edge of the trip.
You'll be fine, Paul.
It's pretty... No, I'm just saying it's pretty... It's going to be a pretty good trip.
You're going to get some food in your system and you'll feel really good.
Dude, I don't know if I want to have food cooked right in front of me while I'm tripping on shrooms.
Don't worry about it. I'll help you.
Paul's like, what if I want to cook my own hand or something?
Yeah, seriously. Or what if
the fire looks beautiful. Oh I must touch it.
That is not going to happen.
Oh, Jesus, guys. What if I accidentally, like, burn my hand? Oh, no!
God.
Micro.
All right. So, first part of the Crazy People segment tonight, we have...
No.
This is entitled, Tommy Sotomayor Gets Exposed by Whites and PETA as a Cat Abuser.
Okay.
Video proof. What?
All right.
What's up,
baby?
How you doing?
Sure,
what's up,
Tommy?
Black guy.
No, this is a fucking. This is just to get by. Just to get. Who did that?
I don't know.
Anyway, it's like in the Dilated Peoples or some shit. Like, he's always talking about people stealing his content. Hey, everybody, Tommy Sotomayor here. Sotomayor here. And they're stealing my content. But here's a beat from a fucking song back in the 90s.
I wonder if this is the cat that was in his car.
Probably.
Most likely.
But
some
now
reason
he knows
I woke
it.
Up and she had done taken the liberty to lay under my arm. And, well, lay on top of my arm with her stomach showing.
Okay.
Arms up and dead sleep.
Wow.
Hey, girl.
This is kind of creepy.
Just wanted to...
He's grabbing a pussy.
Show this because
he's like Trump, dude.
White people have
I just
want to
hear this beat. You're going to get flagged for this beat if you keep playing it.
Okay.
It's a popular ass beat.
So why doesn't he get flagged for it?
I'm just saying, like...
He probably doesn't. I mean, what the
we
fuck
might,
is going on,
not,
dude?
Yeah,
it's
no.
Naked?
This is well known.
He's like
this is
naked
getting weird,
letting the
dude.
Cat walk on his naked body
we're watching
and
watching a fucking cat video made by Tommy.
I'm playing with my pussy naked in bed.
Uh-huh.
Dude. Tommy,
so
you got issues.
Is
yeah, I can't even watch this. This is
this
garbage.
This is weird.
Yeah.
I can't believe this even exists.
All right, so the next video we have is actually... It was a video that the Vigilant Christian did back on Halloween. He interviews a Satanist.
Satan, 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 Satan.
All right. Hey, everyone. It's TVC Mario, and you're here for a very special Halloween expose.
I don't think I brought on
our friend here, Angel. This is, I believe, third time or fourth time?
Fourth time.
This is the fourth show.
If
you haven't seen the previous ones, I'll make sure to link them up in the description section below. Angel is a friend of mine who's come on the YouTube channel several times to have a discussion with me on all sorts of different topics.
I don't think you're supposed to be friends with Satanists.
Summon demons and the reality of the spirit realm. We've talked about witchcraft, occultism, from a Christian perspective, and also from his perspective. Now, I wanted to go ahead and bring him on today because I thought that this would be a really good interview to have on the topic of what is today Halloween, that I've been calling Halloween. A pagan ritual that is still being practiced today by people who are not fully spiritually aware of what they're getting themselves.
To trademark that shit.
Halloween.
I'm sure it's been used.
Yeah.
No, I always love the insidious, the insidious Halloween shit. It's like Halloween's insidious. We really shouldn't practice.
This dude does have good eyebrows for a Satanist, though.
Yeah,
dude.
He has those Levian eyebrows.
Eyebrows.
Leave it to TJ to make a meaningless, trivial fucking. Hey, that guy's got a fucking nose.
It's true, though.
No, what are you talking about, dude? He's got the fucking classic Levian, like comes up to a point right here eyebrows. That's like a classic villainous eyebrow.
Like he might put like eyeshadow and shit up there to make it
You're
more pronounced.
Piece of shit, Scotty. You're a piece
I noticed
of shit.
It too.
Why are you a piece of shit?
And what I wanted to do by bringing our friend Angel here on today,
Scotty,
is
you know
really
what,
just show
dude,
you.
I got to air some grievances with you, honestly.
Oh
like,
God,
sibling
ever
rivalry.
Ever since you cut your hair, Scotty, you've been a real dick, dude.
Wow.
Ever since you cut your hair, it's just been like a totally different Scotty. I don't know who you are anymore. Can't trust you. Can't take you nowhere. You're just fucking. You're a rageaholic, Scotty, and you're a piece of shit. And it's all because of that haircut, dude. You need to grow your hair back out, Scotty. Can't take this anymore, Scotty.
What you said about me, TJ? What the fuck did you just say about me?
Hey, don't stretch my
shirt,
dude. You
got fucking violent.
Don't stretch.
You got
my shirt.
Fucking
Come
violent,
on,
TJ.
Please don't.
I'm not
do this.
Fucking violent, TJ.
Don't do this, Scotty.
I'm not fucking violent.
Ow. Don't do it, Scotty.
Please
Ow.
Don't break. Hold on, dude. Shit's
Damn,
getting...
Damn, you're getting blurry, Scotty. You're getting blurry.
Well, also, like, the TJ. Mouse is getting moved and shit.
Yeah, you're moving the mouse. You're getting blurry.
Oh, shit, TJ. Don't you ever fucking say that about
You need
me.
To fucking concentrate on this dude's eyebrows, Scotty. That's what's important
Not only
here.
From a Christian perspective...
But a Satanist perspective.
You know, and you see that there's a spiritual component, but definitely even occultists and Satanists themselves recognize that this day today, Halloween, is a day that... You could say that the veil is thinned, that spiritual and demonic activity is at a higher level today. And, well, to the Christian, this is something to be concerned about. But I guess to the occultist, this is something you guys would celebrate and enjoy. So we're definitely going to have opposing views on this, as we usually do within our
so what's
our
the fucking
little
point?
Interviews yes. that we have.
Because actually,
but that's,
sure.
that's,
say,
that's
like,
the point it, of all of this. Is
if
to,
this guy's not some kind of weird Mario sycophant, it's kind of cool that Mario does this.
Yeah, goes and talks to some Satanist.
Yeah, because you don't see, like, on the 700 Club, fucking Pat Robertson going, and today we have a Satanist.
We're going to hear a little bit about the satanic perspective on things.
So, kudos to Mario, I guess.
Yeah, whatever.
Well, let's
Sorry.
See.
We'll see what this guy
until,
says.
Yeah.
He might
read dialogue from both perspectives on issues that are relevant. So, thanks so much, Angel, for coming on the show once again and putting your beliefs and everything out there to...
Angel.
To the audience, it takes a lot of courage. So
Satan
thanks so much
for sucking his dick.
I'm excited
Talk.
About this. Should be a really great.
I
want to
hear this guy.
Thank you for having me on your show. I really appreciate the dialogue, and I'm sure your audience will find this very interesting conversation that we're about to have.
Absolutely, I think.
Absolutely,
is this one of those things where we should
skip
ahead?
Dialogue.
Yes, it is
pointless.
Everybody should dabble in the spirit realm that we've been
still just Mario blathering.
Oh, because you have the messengers, angels, L of God.
Yeah,
essentially.
So God sends angels to watch over us, but in our prayer and in our spiritual practices, we never open ourselves up.
How big does this guy is talking to?
Just because
Dude,
we
they send me angels all the time,
angels,
bro.
Will masquerade themselves as angels of light. The Bible says that they come to
dude,
us.
No,
to
bro,
be
dude, bro.
Wise,
the colors, man.
The angels are my friends.
Those are the ones to be the
fallen
careful,
angels.
Mario, you just put the whole Lightworker and New Age community on blast then, because that's what they'll do.
That's
is
right.
they'll contact these high vibrating spirits
People use them as like dildos and vibrators and shit.
Shit.
Capture a high vibrating spirit.
So now,
put that shit on
your
clit.
Criteria to hang out or talk to Mario. You just have to be fucking crazy. Hey Mario, I have sensed in the stratosphere like high vibrating entities. Like, what could that be? Those are the aliens that are trying to take over everything. Let's be friends. You know, like what?
Mm-hmm. Fucking vibrating angels.
Ology to contact like divine beings.
Yeah,
which
I guess
is wrong.
I don't know if
to you.
Right, and I don't know if you remember me and I think I shared this with you in one of our interviews where I actually
can you guys just like play Magic the Gathering or something?
Yeah, used to be a light worker.
Or do something like where it's like still fanciful and you get to make a bunch of shit up, but you like realize there's no real bearing on reality.
I love the shit this dude does with his hands during this fucking conversation.
Yes.
I was like,
contemplating my next evil deed as a Satanist. Yes. What will I do today? Ah, yes, I think I'll roast a child.
And then I will debate the vigilant Christian Mario.
This is hardly a debate.
You're still there, situation.
Yeah, I wonder if his,
squabbling over.
Wonder if his
add
him
to the group call.
You want
to
try it?
Bring him on.
Bring him
Who
on.
Is it?
Bring him on. It's your favorite.
Bring him on.
Bring him on. Bring him on.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Let's try to get him on here. Call failed.
Oh, failed.
Boo.
Try again, I guess.
Patreon. Failed immediately.
Patreon.
He's not got us blocked or something.
Yeah, he's not online. Or he's blocked you again.
Yeah, he's constantly doing back
He's probably blocked you again because he's online right now, which means he's running his hangout through Skype again.
This is ground control to Major Dorn. Whatever.
Who cares about him? Let's see more Satanist versus Vigilant Christian.
Yeah.
It kind of sucks.
Yeah, I'm tired of hearing Mario.
Yeah, this really sucks.
Mario's voice is great. Mario's
the only one talking.
Shit.
Yeah,
this guy
it's a one-sided conversation.
And he's
of
like,
course. And plus, this is what Mario is putting up, too. I mean, we already know that Mario's not going to put something up if he thinks he came out looking bad.
Oh, yes, I worship Satan. Oh.
Satan.
Is there some more of that AC/DC ground up there?
I think there is.
Yes, there is.
There is.
Antichrist, devil's
I wish
children.
There was someone we could call.
Who are you going to call? Somebody.
Do you have anybody on the list that would just pick? You used to do that to me all the time. Like, you call me and I'd be in the middle of shit.
Not really.
Well, every once in a while you dropped in
no,
on
no,
me.
I mean, like, no, we're saying, like, we don't really have that anymore.
Oh, you
like,
don't have that
like
list anymore?
Like that.
Oh, that sucks.
Because, like, we have to be careful.
It's like there's any number of people that I know would drop in.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
What's have you guys heard of Hymnalysis?
Hymnalysis.
Who's
yeah.
that? All right.
You guys have never heard of him? He did this really, really funny Brett Keane parody.
Oh, is there still some in here?
I guess there might be.
I think you should put him on the show. He's great.
He is great.
Hey, Paul.
I've heard of him. Ben's going to hit it.
It's like it hits.
Hey, Paul.
It hits
hit
like
this
a truck.
Fucking bong. Da, 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 da.
It hits like a fucking truck.
Hey, Paul. Weed, man.
Yeah, kinda.
That's awesome, dude.
It's been what this trip has been like so far.
Dude, I wish we could still play Hey Scotty's without those fucking Cristiano faggots
I know.
Trying
Fuck
to stop
the Cristiano
us.
Brothers.
I think the Bible Fuck Reloaded guys are taking them on, though. So maybe if they win, then
go
we can,
Hugo
then we can play
and Jake.
It again.
Go Hugo.
If they win their case, we're totally playing like a big, huge Hey Scotty marathon.
Do a whole fucking episode.
Yeah.
We'll
do an episode of nothing but Hey Scotty's.
Dude, people used to send me those all the time. Some of them were hilarious.
I know, man. Yeah. That was some funny fucking shit.
We could have Hugo and Jake on to do a victory lap and fuck on some Hey Scotty's with us.
I want to get one of them lives close to us, so we should like try to. I want to try to get him out here. I forget which one it is.
What about Cal Chuchesta? Do you have Cal Chuchesta on your Skype? Or I'm sorry. I didn't mean to dox him. Anthony Fantano.
He's on here, but he's not online.
Shit. At least, fuck you, Anthony.
Either that or he's
try
invisible.
To call him. Let's see.
Yeah.
Give it a shot.
See if he's just away.
Give it a fucking shot.
Anthony.
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 Anthony,
come on,
it's
our
Kelton.
Fucking show, you piece of shit. We ran out of videos and we fucking got time to fill and we need somebody's. Come on, you fucking piece of garbage.
Anthony, answer your phone.
No,
we'll
let
phone.
Me do it. We'll let me do
answer
it.
Answer your phone, Anthony. Come on, please.
It's Cal Chuchesta, Anthony, and I'm stuck in hell again. Anthony, help, help, Anthony.
There's an egghead.
Call him.
Call egghead.
No. Really?
Maybe not.
Nah, not egghead.
My initial reaction was, who cares, call him, but then I thought,
G-Man.
Egghead?
G-Man, yeah. G-Man in here.
I was not prepared for this.
What
amazing
you
atheist.
Hear is not a test. I'm a rapping to the beat. I give you a pickle for a nickel, and I'll hit you with the missile. I'm too fast for you to cut me with
is
the sickle.
Is he joining?
I don't know.
Well, it's calling him.
Christian
Paul, that
G-Man.
Was actually too good to be G-Man.
I said a hip hop, a hibby dibby dibby to the hibby hibby hop, and you don't stop. I'm rocking to the bang bang, boogity beatbox, the rhythm of the boogity beat.
That's some old school shit there, Paul.
Is he there? Like, what the fuck's going on with G-Man?
That's some it's rapper's
keeps,
delight.
He keeps trying to call him. He ain't answering.
Sugar Hill
fuck
gang.
You, G-Man.
Fuck G-Man.
Who else we got?
No one.
Nobody.
Hold really? On. Hold on. I'll find someone. Where's fuck?
Where's fuck? I don't know. I never seen him.
Yeah. I'll introduce you later, TJ.
Episode 6.
Where the fuck did he go? Stop doing that shit, TJ.
Fucking much, TJ. On this
fuck
episode.
You. I'm just trying to fill the fucking time so there's something going on. But might that, as well be at least me doing
we were actually having a conversation, though.
Are you actually, so are you even tripping
it was
TJ?
Boring, though.
No, I'm not tripping.
I ain't tripping.
You ain't tripping?
Look at the way his legs are shaking around.
Yeah, that's like the initial stages, maybe.
It is.
Oh, yeah, dude. TJ's starting to trip, you can tell.
It's starting to hit my body. It ain't
not,
hit my mind
yeah, you're
yet.
Not, yeah, you're not like totally yet. I'm gonna look at
I
Paul.
Haven't pried open my third eye yet.
How you feeling, yeah. Paul?
I'm starting to trip. I haven't pried open my third eye yet, but I'm getting there.
Coming soon. Coming soon.
Open my third
prying
eye.
Open my third eye.
See, his legs are like fucking flapping. He's like,
some say
we should make
comic.
Our guests do something.
Let's do.
Yeah, what do you got for me?
What do you? What can you do? What's your talent?
Yeah, what's your hidden talent?
We need something man. From you.
Patreon's got talent.
It's at this fuck guy.
Hey, what can you do, dude?
Do something.
What do you do?
Do a little dance.
Hello.
Do
oh,
a
shit. Shirt guy's here.
Shirt guy's
oh,
here.
Oh, shit. How's everybody doing?
Shirt guy.
Shirt guy.
Fucking shirt guy.
Yeah, I'm actually in Ribey's person. Rabbit right now.
Oh, shit. Ribeye
yeah,
Jenkins.
So my camera's not going to be working.
I heard you're- about Ribeye ooh. Up there. You don't want to go near his property. He cut your leg off with a buck knife, he will.
Ribeye Jenkins.
Good old Ribeye Jenkins. Oh, he a good man. He always pays his debts. That's the problem with him.
Okay.
That's the problem with him.
That's too.
What?
Yeah. That's
how's
the problem
everybody
with him,
doing?
I don't even know, Paul.
How's we're everyone doing? Good, doing? We're doing all right.
How are you guy? Doing, shirt guy?
What kind of shirt do you want to see, shirt guy?
Yeah. Do you have like a shirt that you've thought of that like this is the fucking shirt I hope DP makes?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking you.
Well, honestly, I'd like to have the shirt that's got the three. It was a banner on I think the. Drunken Peasants Facebook page.
Yeah.
Which one? What?
It's I don't know if they're 8-bit, but
oh
the
pixel
oh,
art.
That one.
Yeah. The it's just of them three. Yeah.
Well,
it's the 12
banner
too.
Better,
no, it's fine.
No,
it's cool.
No, Paul.
Paul. I'd buy that shirt too. That's the old shit is cool. Dude, you gotta realize
Paul.
Shirt guy's fucking pre-Paul. Way pre-Paul. Yeah.
Paul
pre-Paul.
Not included.
Paul
back when the
included.
Show was good. You guys ever notice everyone's always telling us the show used to be good?
It was a catalyst.
Also didn't
one
used
event.
To have Paul.
Yeah.
Kind of interesting.
Yep, there it is.
Sure, it's just a coincidence, though.
Hey, correlation is not causation,
yeah,
TJ.
Yeah, I'm sure you're right about that.
I'm sure I'm right about that, too.
Yeah, man.
Is that you conceding an argument to me?
Yeah. No, I'm just saying I'm sure you're right, man.
What if sure there was right. A shirt guy shirt?
I was thinking about that. Would you buy a shirt guy shirt?
Yeah, well, somebody actually designed two of them.
Really?
Really? I haven't
yeah.
seen them.
Oh.
I haven't seen them either.
Yeah, it was a Deep Blue Joseph or
Deep
Final Fantasy Deviant on YouTube.
You know,
Final Fantasy Deviant.
You know, Scotty.
I want to fuck Cloud in the ass.
It's my unfortunate responsibility to report to the community out there that Paul has tested positive for performance-enhancing video game wrestling substances.
Oh, my God.
And has thus violated
these allegations. I deny
them. He has violated the wellness policy of the Drunken Peasants Video Game Wrestling League, and thus he will be stripped of the titles.
Yeah, these are disturbing
allegations. And we will hold tournaments to
determine new
champions.
Am I allowed to speak in my own public lynching?
You are not. You are
new
not.
Champions
not,
for the vacant titles.
Not allowed
titles.
To speak, Paul. We've heard enough of your you lies, you violated the Paul. Trust of this yep, community, yep. Paul.
We've heard enough of your scandalous
you
fucking
know,
lies,
I
Paul,
was
Zago.
Fucking I was, Paul. I knew something was up when Paul kept winning.
Yep. The official vote, I vote to strip Paul
yes.
of both of
I
the
vote.
Titles.
Yes,
and
I vote
the
same.
We will decide.
That I won by the sweat
I second
of my
the motion.
Brow.
In a fatal,
by cheating.
Fatal four-way match.
Wrong.
Tonight on Twitch.
Wrong.
For the new heavyweight championship, and then we'll decide the Intercontinental later.
Wrong. I need more performance-enhancing shrooms before I have that fatal.
Oh, yeah, that's going to happen.
Shrooms are allowed.
Yes.
Performance-enhancing
Paul crossed the line.
Shrooms.
This is ground control to Major Tom.
Okay.
What's up, ground control?
Look at Paul. Look at Paul's fucking face,
Paul,
dude.
Paul, make that face that you made when on Halloween.
Face.
Yeah, the Halloween face that you kept making when I don't know how to do it.
Was it like
yeah.
this?
He's like, yeah, like this huge smile on his face. He's like, ooh, like that.
I don't know what I was doing.
Do you remember when we were watching that Green Jello dude. Fucking not commercial, that music video, and it's like, nope.
Oh,
I was like, oh.
Every time that happened, Paul would be like, oh.
All right, audience. Before we end the show, this will be fun. Everyone in the chat, tell us which one of these two we should kick right now. Like, which one would you rather have us kick before we end the show?
Patreon guy
kick or shirt guy.
Wow. Oh, yeah. Go ahead and plead your case.
Yeah, go
tell
ahead.
Us why you think they should kick shirt guy.
Look, man,
shirt guy
actually
is
probably
proud of a picture with Scotty, so that's definitely a point off right there.
Yeah. That and he doesn't even have his fucking camera on. And the guy says maybe like five fucking words every month. Dude doesn't talk. Even in Hangouts, he doesn't talk. Kick this motherfucking shirt guy.
Wow. Strong words coming from Egghead 2.0.
Wow.
Sure,
yeah,
guy.
Egghead 2
so.
Has bigger. Yeah, he doesn't.
I don't even care. Okay, so.
That's the true drunken peasant.
I'm just
kick
glad
the other
I was
one.
Yep, kick the other one.
You're
kick
gone.
Chris. Chris, you're gone.
Bye, Chris.
Get out of here, motherfucker.
He doesn't even want to be here.
Get the fuck out of here.
Just like a real drunken peasant doesn't want to be here on this fucking garbage ass show.
It's true.
Fuck this show, guys.
Oh, true. Oh!
There's
oh,
the real drunken
yeah.
peasant.
Yeah. Man. You don't give a shit about this show either, do you, shirt guy? Fuck this show. Right? Fuck this show, you guys. Scotty, what do you say about this show? Is this a good show? Or is it a shit show, Scotty?
If you're on it, shit.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
I only have one thing to say about this show.
Yeah.
One if by land,
two if by sea, three is for the manatee. One if by land, two if by sea, three is for the manatee. One if by land, two if by sea, three is for the manatee.
The end. Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. Like it. Go use our Amazon.
We're done,
thing.
Bitches. Manatee. Good night.
Love you, shirt guy.
Yeah, and all the shirts are back on sale if you guys want to get
sell
some.
Them shirts. Buy them shirts. Yeah.
Oh, and another thing. Don't forget to check the links for our dominatrix, Mistress Gin.
Juniper Gin.
And the Wheel of Misfortune
go,
prize fund as
go
well.
Go to her
but
stuff.
Yes,
help her out
because well.
She needs to come out here, and it's not cheap.
It isn't.
Yeah, this is not a cheap place to come visit. It's way the fuck out of the way unless you live in this area
so,
or like Portland or something.
Juniper, my mistress, needs help. Please help her if you want to have her.
It's going to make all of this work so well.
If you want to have
Paul
her assist you suffer. In jerking.
In masturbation.
In the show. End it.
End it.
End it now.
End your life.
End it all.
Okay, cool.
End the fucking show.
If you're wondering what podcast to listen to next, visit the dark, seedy underworld of crime by subscribing to the Secrets, Crimes, and Audio Tape podcast. It features tales of crime, love, mystery, and conspiracy with actors you know and love. Some are dramas, some are comedies, but all are thrilling. The latest episode is called Severed Threads, and it's about faith, greed, and revenge. Make sure you don't miss a single episode. Visit the link in our description below and subscribe to Secrets, Crimes, and Audio Tape on iTunes, Stitcher, Wondery.com, or wherever you listen to podcasts. Secrets, Crimes, and Audio Tape is like a TV drama or comedy, but only using sound and your imagination. Check out the show notes for the link and subscribe to Secrets, Crimes, and Audio Tape today.